Paradigm Shift,
an educational comedy.
It's not a cause, not a movement.
It's not a social group you can slap a label on to.
It's an idea. It's an intention.
It's an intuition.
A mindset in which reality can be explored.
A genuine expression.
A sermon.
Critical thinking and imagination.
To look inward upon ourselves.
To better understand the external world around us.
And yes,
few egos are bound to be bruised.
With our silly, strange, politically incorrect.
Your current building style of going about things.
Real and raw honesty.
Which invites you to be
to the fullest.
Hello, everybody. Welcome to yet another edition of Paradigm Shift and Educational Comedy. And today's, well, it's going to be at least three videos. So the first one is Water Purification Test Part 1. The description is Dave Kelso Time Warrior volunteers to be a guinea pig for a water purification test. Dave Kelso Time Warrior and Richard Hamilton, General Tate, explain what this test is and how we're going to proceed. And so nobody's confused. Part one is, oh, and Kristen is calling me on Skype. This is interesting. Okay, hold on a minute. Hey, Kristen, we are on a hangout right now and you are like audible and like my viewing audience is looking at me, talking with you. And we're doing a hangout on the water purification test stuff. I was just giving my little opening rant there. Did you want to join us? Or do you have the capability of joining us at the moment? Or
I'm actually going to be going to bed, but I hope it all goes well with this hangout.
Yep. Because obviously I got my stuff and I was going to, you know, be talking about that and explaining that and, you know, going through the website and so on and so forth and, you know, talking about what type of water purification test we're referring to and all that good stuff. So we're about to jump into that. But I hope you have a good night.
Yeah, you too.
Yep. Catch you later. Okay, well, that was interesting. Anyway, I guess Kristen couldn't participate this time. Either way, you know, sorry about that interruption, so I will proceed. In each version of this video, just so everybody's not confused, you're going to see this hangout because version number one is going to be just the hangout, so you're going to see no, you know, classic opening, you know, paradigm shift and educational comedy intro stuff. And it's just going to be us talking about it and me demonstrating. I got the little bottle here and I got the manual and, you know, obviously we're going to do screen shares on the website. And there's three videos that are kind of attached to this. You know, three like full presentations that they've done that, as far as I could tell, are, you know, free Creative Commons, you know, fair use, whatever. So we can inject that. So this video is going to be me reading out of this and showing you guys what the videos are and what this is about. Me and Rich have already watched the video. And then, you know, me and Rich will be talking about our experiences with the first video. There's three. We've only watched one of the three. Now, the second version of this, part two, is going to begin with exactly what you're watching right now, but I'm going to, you know, load this hangout into the nice little Kaden Live editor on Linux, and there's going to be a part where I cut it, and then I insert the first video, and then after that video, it'll resume with, you know, mine and Rich's, you know, conversation about that video. So obviously, if you are catching this at a point to where it's not the live stream and the second video has already been created, then you can actually feel free, if you want, to completely stop watching this and then, you know, go to the second video. Obviously, if you are watching this live, then, you know, the second video hasn't been created yet, so you're just kind of stuck with this for now. The third video is going to be, you know, similarly as I just explained, but it's going to include all three, you know, freaking videos that are on the website back to back to back. And then, you know, mine and Rich's discussion after it, you know, the discussion we're kind of about to have. So yeah, but first, obviously, the stuff is called Advia Clarity. And there's the bottle of it. It's a 2 ounce bottle. And of course, here's the manual I'm going to be reading from. And I'm going to switch to screen share mode. Infinite Infinity Google Hallway. Woo! Okay. So on waterliberty.com, under presentations, the video that we were talking about is the, you know, the first video, Water Freedom Webinar. And if you're watching, you know, part 2 or part 3, then somewhere about here is probably where I'm going to, like, put my cut and then go right straight into that. So let's roll that beautiful bean footage.
Hello, everybody. My name is Casper, and welcome to the Water Freedom Webinar. My main aim here today is to share with you a breakthrough new technology that has the ability to remove deadly contaminants, such as heavy metals, from your water, but not just from your water, from your body. And you'll see how you can turn the worst water on earth into pristine, pure, clean drinking water, all with just a few drops from an eyedropper bottle. So, some of the other things you're about to learn today is what contaminants are likely in your drinking water right now, how detrimental they are to your health, why our water supply is in more danger right now than ever before in history, a cutting-edge breakthrough science about phase 4 water and how it affects your health, what is mineral deficiency and how to deal with it. So before we begin, if you haven't been on one of my webinars before, let me tell you a little bit about me, because you probably want to know who this guy talking is with a bad haircut. This is a picture of me back when I did have a haircut. And I'm the author of numerous books, ebook story on sustainability, biodome construction, and spiritual awakening. My main aim is to always constantly have my pulse on breakthrough technologies that have the power to transform our planet. And I tend to attract these projects, these technologies towards me because I have the ability to spread the word about them in a very powerful way with my experience in internet and advertising, internet advertising, internet marketing, and my whole team. I'm fascinated with the fact that most of the breakthrough technologies that could have solved most of the problems on the planet today, they're already here. They're just not being proliferated because of corporate reasons, corporate greed, political reasons. So for some reason, they go unnoticed or buried. There's usually a lag time between ideas being discovered these days and actually the realization of them revolutionizing the planet. For example, electric cars have been around for 100 years, but it's only now that Elon Musk is spreading electric cars and starting Tesla, and within 10 years, likely all of our cars will be electric, at least according to him. So here's a few of the companies I'm involved with: Silent Furnace, Biodome Revolution, Advia Clarity, Water Liberty, Laundry Magnetic Laundry System, the SOAR Project, which is an anti-gravity project. That's some of the things I'm involved in. So why is this webinar important to you? Well, in school, you know, we're usually told that our bodies are about 2/3 water. Now that's true, but if you look at it as if you had a whole body meat bag, and here's the liver, and here's the water, here's the brain, and here's some water stored over here between the cells. Yes, but on a molecular level, And even a cellular level, the trillions of cells in your body are actually composed of 99% water. So if you look at a cell, and don't just look at outside of it, but look inside of it, inside the cell, what's in there? Well, it's mostly water. Inside the center of the cell, it's mostly water. In the brain, in those cells, well, hey, there's water. So we're actually 99% water. And here's where it gets interesting. Instead of thinking of yourself as a bag of meat containing water, what you realize is that you're more likely to be water in the form of a human being. I mean, 99.9%, that's a lot of water. Yet it looks very solid, it looks meaty. What makes it alive and function? So that's an interesting way of looking at it. When you start to look at it that way, you begin to realize that water really deserves a second closer look, the water you're drinking on a daily basis. Now, you would think by now that we would know everything there is to know about water, right? I mean, we've had thousands of years to study it, and it's everywhere. I've got water here, lemonade water in my cup. Tastes great, pretty simple stuff. But it turns out it's actually the complete opposite. Water to this day is still the most important and mysterious substance on the planet. It is the key to life, and it does things that even defy the laws of physics. For example, scientists to this day cannot explain how water travels, defying the laws of gravity, travels up to the top of extremely tall trees, like 300 feet trees. It boggles the mind. Another example is our clouds. They can't explain exactly how clouds form, what makes them form, why they form over here like this instead of like that. It's a mystery. So scientists who are in the field of studying water all agree that we barely have a clue as to how water actually interacts with human cells, and top scientists today still can't explain some of the things you're about to see on this webinar. However, a few scientists, like Dr. Gerald Pollack of the University of Washington, which you may have heard of, he's been recently interviewed by Mercola.com, are studying those mysteries and finding out things about water that are quite mind-blowing. For example, the fact that water can store energetic information. It's almost like its own little hard drive, which can store an imprint of energetic information. Water has structure, which has a huge impact on how your cells interact with nutrients and proteins. Water even has a fourth phase. Most of us have heard of liquid, gas, and solid. Of course, liquid can take water can take all those forms. Water also has a fourth one. The cells in your body are surrounded by water, and there's now a mountain of evidence specifically coming out of Dr. Gerald Pollack's research at the University of Washington, which proves the type of water you're drinking is possibly the most important element of your health. Not necessarily what's in that water, but what structure it takes, because it changes how your cells absorb nutrients and how they interact with proteins. It's extremely important. So over the next few minutes, I'm going to show you how you can remove the stuff that's making you sick out of your water and activate the healing properties of your water. So just a little disclaimer here. This information, you can take it or leave it, use it for your own well-being. It's for your educational purposes. But because I value your time, I will be making you a very lucrative offer at the end of the webinar. So you can take that or leave it too. I'll just put that out there. So to start this off, I have a picture of a dead goldfish here. In a fishbowl to kind of put this in perspective. If you've ever had fish as a kid, or if you have some now, if you see this, it's pretty obvious the water is sick. It's not the fish that's sick or the water, you know, it's not a debate. You wouldn't come in there and say, oh, look at this fish, it's got leukemia or cancer, let's dissect it, find out where the tumor came from. It's obvious you didn't change the water and this fish was swimming in its own pee. So if you just change the water, if you change the environment, then the fish will be healthy. So this is a pretty good metaphor, analogy of where we are right now in our culture in terms of how we look at health. We look so much at symptoms, at what, you know, what's the culprit. But the answers are obviously right there in front of us. And as you see during this webinar, this is likely to be true. If you change the environment in your body, you can change your life. That's why I want to look with you right now at what is actually in our water today. So we're pretty screwed right now in terms of our water supply and our environment, and most people don't want to look at this, but I want to go over this with you right now for the next few minutes. This is the part of the webinar where I'm just going to go over a lot of bullet points showing you what's in water right now, and I'll try to go through it quickly because a lot of these things I can't even pronounce and there's a lot of symptoms and diseases that are associated with this. Now keep in mind, these are known studies and research that have been done by the Environmental Working Group, Center of Disease Control, and many other studies. You can get access and links to these at the end of the webinar. I will send you an email with all the scientific references. So first, we have fluoride. Fluoride is in most municipality water, as confirmed by the Central Disease Control and EWG. It's been added to water since the 1950s as a measure for reducing incidence of tooth cavities. So we're told, you know, we're putting this stuff in the water to make your teeth clean. Few people know that it was actually a byproduct of industrial byproduct, and they had to do something with it, and they made up some crap that fluoride is good for you, and they started adding it in the water in the 1950s. Fluoride has been linked to many health effects, including bone disease, systemic disorder, increased risk of cancer, Down syndrome, heart disease, osteoporosis, and bone fracture, immune disorders, low intelligence, renal disorders, Alzheimer's, and allergic reactions. This is a repeat slide here. I have it in here by accident. You know, I mean, I could go deeper and deeper into it because this is like one of the most interesting things. But if you just go to YouTube and type in fluoride documentary, you're going to find a whole slew of documentaries you can watch and go down the rabbit hole on the whole fluoride thing. It is pretty creepy and a little bit disturbing once you start finding out these things, because you start wondering why they're really adding it to the water. And if you follow the conspiracy circles, a lot of people believe that it's being added to the water to dumb down the population. Could be true, I don't know. I'm not advocating that. Fluoride is, it accumulates in your body over time, especially in your bones, and causes havoc. Some studies have shown fluoride accumulates in your pineal gland. Fluoride is a neurotoxin. It affects brain function, especially in young children who are still developing. Heavy metals. You know, this is something that's really a biggie for me here, because I live in South America, where they still put lead in fuel, and they use mercury in the rivers down here, south of us in Peru, to extract gold. People are getting mercury poisoning, lead poisoning, like, it's just scary. The term heavy metal really means metal that is heavy, according to the periodic table. While living things require trace levels of some heavy metals, such as cobalt, manganese, and zinc, other heavy metals, such as lead, mercury, and arsenic, have been proven to have no benefits whatsoever to our bodies and cause adverse and very serious health effects. Lead, like I just mentioned, of course, it's been around for years, and the Roman Empire fell because of lead plumbing. Lead may contaminate water through, well, that's a theory that it fell from lead plumbing. I'm not going to say that as a fact. it's been proven to affect brain function. Lead may contaminate water through corrosion of natural deposits, metal water taps, interior water pipes, or pipes connecting to a house. Even low exposure to lead may result in a variety of health effects, including learning disabilities and behavioral problems in children. Now, most of us think we don't have lead plumbing anymore, which is true in most areas, but that doesn't mean it's gone. It accumulates on surfaces, it's in the soil. Young children, 6 years and under, are at the most risk, as their brains are still developing. For adults, drinking water contaminated with lead in excess may lead to kidney problems and high blood pressure. Here's a picture of lead poisoning in the bones and teeth. Mercury. Mercury is a liquid metal that may contaminate water through erosion of natural deposits, discharge from refineries and factories, landfills, and croplands. Drinking water contaminated with mercury in excess may lead to kidney damage and a wide variety of health problems. Skin discoloration, loss of hair, teeth and nails, transient rashes, hypotonia, muscle weakness, and increased sensitivity to light. Other symptoms may include kidney dysfunction or neuropsychiatric symptoms such as emotional instability, memory impairment, and or insomnia. Arsenic. Arsenic is a tasteless and odorous metal that may contaminate water through erosion, natural deposits, runoff from orchards, and electronic production waste. It's been linked to a wide range of serious health problems, including several forms of cancer, such as bladder, lungs, skin, kidney, nasal passages, liver, and prostate cancer. Non-cancerous effects may include stomach pain, nausea, diarrhea, numbness in hand and feet, discoloration of the skin. So that's just heavy metals alone. And you guys, this isn't just a few odd incidences somewhere in the third world countries. This is in your water right now. The EWG has done a number of studies of what's in tap water. I'm just reading out the research that's been found in North America. Hexavalent chromium 6. This is an interesting one because there's been a movie about it. The Aaron Brockovich movie made it famous. You may or may have not seen it. Hexavalent chromium 6 is highly toxic. It's a heavy metal, and it can occur naturally in the environment. It may contaminate water through leaks in industrial plants and hazardous waste sites. Hexchromium is a known carcinogen that has been linked to lung, nasal, and sinus cancer, according to the EWG. Hexchromium has been detected in the drinking water of at least 72 million Americans in 42 different states. That's another repeat slide, I'm sorry. But when I watched the movie, you know, I thought this was just one story about some town in California and some lawyer fighting for the rights of a few people. It turns out that this is actually in over 89% of the water across the whole country, at least America alone, according to the EWG studies. And this is a map showing a concentration of hexchromium in America. Now, it turns out that the problem is so bad, the concentration of hexchromium in California alone is so high, until recently, that if they actually enforced the law about the maximum amount of allowed chromium 6 in the water, they would have to shut down the water plants and people would go without water. So recently, actually very recently, they just changed the law and they increased the limit of allowed hexchromium in water. So it's not a problem anymore. I'm just kidding, of course it is. Okay, the next things, industrial chemicals, agricultural chemicals, I'm going to go over a bit quickly because there's a lot of long names here and I don't know how to pronounce them all and it's just going to take a lot of time to read all this. I'm going to put my glasses on because my vision powers are running out. Okay, so benzene, it's a volatile organic chemical, and drinking water contaminated with benzene in excess may result in anemia, decreased blood platelets, and increased risk of cancer. BPA, which you may have heard of, it's an endocrine disruptor, which means it may interfere with the endocrine system, producing adverse development, reproductive, neurological, and immune effects. Dimethyl phthalates, I don't know how to pronounce that, have been linked to birth defects and reproductive toxicity. MTBEs associated with liver, kidney damage, and nervous system effects. PCBs, immune deficiencies, problems with thymus gland, reproductive or nervous system, and an increased risk of cancer. VOCs are basically carbon-containing compounds that are contained in a wide variety of commercial, industrial, and residential products like oils, gasoline, solvents, cleaners, degreasers, paints, inks, dyes, refrigerants, and pesticides. A lot of these things end up being flushed down the toilet or back into the water supply by people who are just not conscious of what they're doing. Harmful to the central nervous system, kidneys, or liver. Some VOCs are known or suspected carcinogens. Natural gas drilling is a huge source of VOCs. You may have seen recent documentaries about this, where they're basically trying to extract gas. This is a wide-range problem in Canada, America, and even Europe. And this process releases a lot of VOCs, toxic VOCs, into the water, especially flammable things like methane. In the recent documentary Gasland, which you may have seen, I have some pictures of it here. You know, people are now able to light their taps on fire. They open the water and out comes water with VOCs. You can light it on fire and then they're drinking that. It's just insane. Agricultural chemicals. Agriculture is actually one of the leading causes of water pollution right now. It's been found in over 97 different types of agriculture contaminants have been found in over 250 million people in 46 states. Some of these are herbicides, fungicides, again, some pretty scary names by themselves. Atrazine causes cardiovascular system problems and reproductive difficulties in cancer. EPTC, colon and prostate cancer, cell damage, hormonal interference and reproductive problems, simazine, blood problems, carcinogenicity, reproductive and developmental toxicity, neurotoxicity, and acute toxicity. Now, when you think about one of the most widespread problems these days, when I lived in North America, I heard this all the time, of people having problems with fertility. I mean, of course, a lot of those problems are coming from GMO and just the chemicals in food these days, but if you look at just what's in water alone, it paints a pretty clear picture. I mean, all these things are in our drinking water. It's no wonder people are getting sick and suffering from problems. 1 in 3 people now in America are getting cancer. I think the number is going to rise soon, in my opinion. when you start to look at this, is any wonder? So fungicides, including chlorothalonil, the most used fungicide in the U.S. that is likely a carcinogen. According to a USDA, honeybees that were fed this chemical, which I can't pronounce, were three times more likely to become infected with the parasite Nosema chlorothalonil. So, DDT, dieldrin, diazinon, I mean, you get the point at this stage, you know, what kind of symptoms have we not read out here? Okay, Parkinson's, breast cancer, immune reproductive, nervous system damage, vomiting, that's a new one, nausea, cramps, and diarrhea, slow pulse, respiratory problems, gastrointestinal distress, and urological problems. And there's disinfection products, byproducts. Just the sheer fact of trying to clean the water from all this other stuff leaves a whole other slew of toxic stuff in the water, which is hard for water processing plants to take out. Chlorine, for example, it's in most water. It's widely used to disinfect and kill organic life in water that's harmful. But the reason why it works to kill microorganisms is because it's poison. So think about that. Not only does chlorine affect the taste of water, but drinking chlorinated water in excess may result in nose and eye irritation and stomach discomfort. Chloramine is a disinfectant that is formed when ammonia is added to water containing free chlorine. Drinking water containing chloramine in excess may cause nose and eye irritation, stomach discomfort, and even anemia. And then we have trihalomethanes, THMs, which are tasteless. It's a disinfection byproduct that occurs when disinfectants are added to water that contains organic matter. Drinking water with THMs in excess may result in liver, kidney, or central nervous system problems and an increased risk of cancer. And then we have microorganisms, which the water is typically treated for these with things like chlorine, which we just mentioned, but some microorganisms are very resistant to these things, and they can contaminate the water through human and animal fecal waste. Bacteria such as E. coli, Enterobacter cloacae, Proteomirabilis, can't pronounce these at all, can cause some pretty interesting health effects like diarrhea, urinary tract infections, respiratory illness, and pneumonia. Anything else that we haven't read so far? Viruses. Poliovirus is, of course, a known virus that can lead to paralysis. Rotavirus is one of the most leading causes in over 500,000 deaths each year in children 5 years and under. Now, I'm not sure if this is true for the U.S., as I think they have cleaner water than that, but definitely in third world countries, that's a biggie. Parasites such as Giardia and Crypto, they're very tolerant to chlorine and are usually found in water. So, last but not least, we have pharmaceuticals and basic drugs. Did you know that people flush drugs down the toilet? Where did those end up? Well, these are very, these chemicals are sometimes very hard to get out of water, and they end up recirculating through the system. Recent studies, an investigation done by the Associated Press has found trace levels of pharmaceuticals in drinking water supplied to 46 million people in 24 major cities in the U.S. It is estimated that at least 271 million pounds of pharmaceuticals have been released into waterways that supply our drinking water. Some of these pharmaceuticals have found to be antibiotics, anticonvulsants, mood stabilizers, and hormones. Over-the-counter drugs have also been detected. So, that's it for the doom and gloom in this webinar. I just wanted to go over that in case you weren't aware of what actually is in your water right now, very likely in your water. I don't know, maybe you live in like some pristine paradise where these things are not in the water, but our water system is connected. It's not like isolated pockets of water. I mean, there's rain circulating water, then underground, there's waterways that are connected, and you know, there's this plumbing system through cities. It's this stuff is pretty much everywhere. I mean, right now you can read some studies where they're finding plastic in the Arctic in the ice, like BPA plastic chemicals. That's how bad it is. It's everywhere. So the question is, what do we do? What is the solution? And that's why I'm here today with you in this webinar, because I'm going to show you. Now, of course, choice number one, like most people, is to just remain oblivious. You know, my water looks fine, it's clean, it's fine. I've been in people's homes and they're like, yeah, if you got clean water, you can drink this well water, it tastes great. Have some, and I drink it, it just tastes like crap. Or I can smell chlorine in their tap water, which means, of course, it's not good for you. And then you can have choice number two, which is to get a reality check and do what I do, find a solution and do it. And that's why I'm here with you today. So what if I told you that there was something so powerful that it could remove and neutralize heavy metals, like lead, mercury, and arsenic, take that stuff out of your water, but not just from your water, get this, from your body as well. You can get these accumulated toxins out of your body, help your body remove those things. I'll show you how that works. You can remove fluoride, chloride, and chlorine almost instantly from your water. Remove harmful microorganisms like E. coli and coliform. Remove agriculture chemicals, disinfectants, industrial chemicals, and pharmaceutical chemicals. Basically all the crap I just told you about. With this, you can literally take the worst water in the world and purify it into clear, clean, pristine, mineral-rich drinking water, all with just a few drops of an eyedropper bottle. You could give me a glass of putrid water, black water that kids are in Africa are dying from with all this crap in it, and use this to turn that into drinking water that would actually have healing properties. So instead of just talking about this, I'm going to show you some amazing videos so you can just watch this in action and see how it works. Here we go. All right, so what I'm going to play for you here in this video is you're going to see how black mica takes a totally filthy pond, just full of slime and algae and all kinds of contaminants, and just takes everything out in a matter of hours. As you can see, this video was filmed in Japan quite a while ago, and the quality is not that great, but just watch, because this is just quite mind-blowing. I'm going to play it for you right now. So you can see this whole pond is extremely dirty. It's got all kinds of stuff in there, and what they're doing, they're putting the black mica in and introducing it into the minerals into the water. Showing the animation of how these particulates respond to the oxygenated water from these minerals. And you can see almost instantly, with a matter of hours, these contaminants floating up to the top. And they're just scooping it up, and you can begin to see what's left is just this pristine, clear drinking water. When you can see what's left is this pristine water. And I think this guy's even going to test it now and even drink it in this video. It's amazing. This is originally a 10-minute video. I just shortened it down here for you guys into 1 minute, because obviously we don't have time to watch a whole 10-minute video. All right, so in the second video, what you have is this huge pool of water full of dark green slime. It's just nasty. And they put the theme rocks, the high concentrated black mica, into the water. And again, the particulates just flow it up, and they can easily be removed just by scooping them from the surface here, leaving the water totally pristine and clear. All right, so in this video, I want to show you exactly how this works and what happens when you put this in your tap water or in dirty water, what you can expect. It's quite miraculous. So on the left here, we have a jar of normal distilled water. So this is just pure water. There's nothing in it. On the right, we have a jar of pretty nasty water. As you can see, it's mercury. You can barely see through it. It's pretty disgusting. So what we're going to do, I'm going to play the video right now. What we're going to do is put a few drops of black mica extract into the jar with the really nasty water. And you can see what happens immediately. The water smokes up as the minerals are beginning to interact with all the toxins, all the contaminants in that water. What's going to happen is they're going to smoke up, clump together, and fall to the bottom of the glass over the next few hours. And if you put a few drops of black mica, as you can see here, into the other jar, nothing happens, because there's nothing in that water. Hope you can see. The video quality here is not so great because of the internet connection for you as well, but in the right jar, there's this smoky effect happening. Now, this smoke usually only happens when the water is really, really bad. If you just put this in your tap water, don't expect this huge explosion of smoke to happen. But what you will see over several hours, I think the video will cut to it soon, is, yeah, here we go. I'm going to pause it. What you're seeing here at the bottom of the glass are all the contaminants that have been turned inert. They have been clumped together through a magnetic process and fall into the bottom of the glass, leaving the rest of the water pristine, clear, and drinkable. We start with what appears to be clean glass of water from a reputable local source of bottled water. Now keep in mind, it looks clean. We're told it's clean. Even the label says it's clean, filtered, pure, you know, drinking water. And to this, we add a few drops of Adia Clarity, black mica, magnetic sulfate minerals.
In the beginning, if we zoom in, you can already start to see, even though it's hard, especially if you're watching this on a low resolution video, maybe on the internet, the water begins to change texture a little bit. It's a little bit less transparent and almost a little bit yellow. This is about half an hour in. You can see the water's turning just a little bit yellow, a little bit more yellow. It's about an hour in. You can actually see now, I'm going to pause it, all the little particulates. You can begin to see these things clumping together in the water. It looks almost like dust, like a cloud of dust and specks in the water clumping together. They'll begin to get a bit more pronounced as we get into an hour and a half now here, the time lapse. You can see them moving and clumping together. And this is just really quite amazing. Remember, we started with a clean glass of water, completely transparent. You would, if someone asks you if there was something in that water that was harmful, you'd probably say no. But now, as we're almost 2 hours in, you can clearly see the stuff collecting together, clumping together, and falling to the bottom of the glass. This is about 2 hours in. You can already see the stuff collecting at the bottom. At the top, it's a bit more clear. I zoomed in here a little bit to show you the stuff collecting at the very bottom of the glass. And I let this glass sit for a day. And the next day, this is pretty much what you're left with, is perfectly clean, pure, clean drinking water, full with life-giving minerals, and all the stuff that makes you sick is collecting at the bottom, the heavy metals, the chemical and biological contaminants. You can see at the bottom of the glass.
All right, and we're back. I hope you enjoyed those videos. So what this essentially is black mica extract. I'm going to tell you about the science of it now and how it works. What you saw there in the first video is when I took a clean, what looked to be a clean glass of water and added this in, and over just an hour, our glass looked like this. What this does is through a magnetic process, it allows the water to cleanse itself. The water literally, as if it had its own immune system, begins to push everything out of it that's not supposed to be in there naturally, and it clumps together through a magnetic process and sinks to the bottom. What you're seeing, these dust particles here, is the water doing exactly that. All these things are beginning to clump together. I mean, an hour ago, this looked like pristine, just transparent water, and all we did was added a few minerals to it. So what is happening? It's super amazing. Usually, depending on how long you leave the water, all that stuff will contaminate, will clump together and fall to the bottom. And you can take it out through a coffee filter and have amazing water. Now, what is left at the top here, this clean water, is not just pure water. That's water with essential sulfate, magnetic sulfate minerals, the same stuff that is found in mineral hot springs and mineral springs that have been known to have healing properties throughout the ages. And people are experiencing miraculous healing by going to these hot springs and mineral springs if you look this stuff up. This is the same stuff. It's just quite amazing. The stuff at the bottom, it's not just the bad stuff that fell to the bottom. It's actually been neutralized through a magnetic process. It's been turned inert. These contaminants are no longer harmful to the body. Your body can actually expel them because they're in a sulfate form. It is just amazing. I'm super excited about this. Can you tell? Okay, so as you saw there, just in that experiment, just because you can't see it, it doesn't mean it's not there. And this is why I love using this stuff. This is actually the bottle that comes in. Added Clarity, Black Mica, Minerals. This bottle has been beat up by my use. And I don't know if you guys could see that. I don't know, my camera is on there. Anyway, it allows you to see what's in your water. And water that you previously thought was healthy and clean, you put a few drops of this in, wait, and you see what is really going on. So in a specific lake in the USA, in California, this has actually been recently used to heal a whole lake. What they did is they found there was a lake, which I cannot name because of publicity reasons, they don't want us to release the name. But you can see the paperwork and the experiments. At the end of the webinar, I'll send you links to the studies. The E. coli and the coliform population in this lake was just off the charts. Over 100,000 colonies per milliliter, and the coliform was double that. After they added the right amount of black mica extract to the lake basically healed itself. Something extraordinary happened. The E. coli disappeared. It went down to 10 colonies per milliliter, and the coliform went down to 20 colonies from 200,000 colonies per milliliter. Now, that's unheard of because these minerals essentially removed 99.999% of the top two invading bacteria in this body of water. It's just unheard of.
So, you've seen the videos. I told you basically what this is, but let me tell you the story and go a little bit more in depth. This was invented by a Japanese doctor by the name of Asao Shimonishi, and I say he cracked the code to healing water and unleashing the healing powers of water. Dr. Asao Shimonishi was charged with the task of finding a way to clean up radioactive waste after World War II in Japan. And one day in 1968, he was sitting at a beach admiring a peculiar tree. And what caught his attention is that, like in the little picture here I have in the slide, this tree was growing out of a rock surrounded by nothing. He was asking, first of all, how is this tree surviving? Where is this getting its mineral source, its nutrients? It's surrounded by salt water, which we of course know is stuff doesn't grow on unless you're growing palm trees or coconut trees. What's happening here? And he began to study the rock it was growing out of, and that's when the magic began to reveal itself. What he found is that the rock contained biotite, or black mica, which is a powerful combination of Earth's naturally occurring minerals embedded in granite, sulfate minerals. And he worked and played with this for 20 years, as a matter of fact, and discovered that you can use these sulfate minerals to activate water's natural ability to cleanse itself of chemical and natural contaminants. Excuse me. I mean, like you saw in the video, the water literally cleanses itself. It's as if it has its own immune system and it just pushes everything that's not supposed to be in the water out. That is awesome. That's what it does. Now, remember, you are 99.9% water. If this does this to water, imagine what it could do for you and your body and your health. We'll see that. So that's what I just talked about here. You know, when you're sick, what does your body do? It unleashes your immune system. This is almost the equivalent. I mean, this is a metaphor. I'm not taking this word for word. This is how I look at it. Through this magnetic process, it allows water to do the same thing. So to understand how this works, you really have to get out of the mindset of filtration. When trying to purify water, most people think about water filters. And water filters are great. They're a step in the right direction. It's a pretty simple concept. You make holes, little perforations, small enough of them so water can pass through. Big molecules like heavy metals can't pass through or compounds. And water passes through and you have clean water. That's a step in the right direction, and we know filters work, but they don't work entirely. Most people know that filters don't take everything out. There's different grades of filters. And the simple fact is nature simply doesn't work that way. Filtering water or using reverse osmosis, it's a step in the right direction, but it's not the complete answer. And what I mean by that is that as much as you can filter water, you're never going to get those healing properties into the water. You're never going to have water that that life can thrive in. And by healing water, what do I mean by that? Most of us have no idea what that is because we're so alien to this concept. We turn our tap on, we get bottled water at this point. If we live in cities, we don't know what real water tastes like, what real water feels like in our body. Most of us have never experienced this, but hopefully soon you will. See, nature is much more intelligent than what we commonly believe. And Dr. Shimonishi found a way, or rather, he cracked the code, so to speak, to healing water naturally. He created a patented process to extract these minerals and turn them into an extract. Sorry, to take these minerals and turn them into an extract from biotite for water purification. He became the authority on treatment and cleaning water in Japan. His discovery has been used in the treatment of raw sewage and wastewater for use in agriculture, horticulture, and aquatics. A very interesting fact is that these ionic sulfate minerals are normally found near volcanoes, in slow-moving magma eruptions and underground volcanic vents. We'll come back to this later, but if you think about what I said earlier about mineral springs and hot springs, this is all connected. The puzzle fits together. Because this works with nature, it doesn't just remove the bad stuff from your water, like I said. Within 72 hours, it actually neutralizes harmful contaminants and turns them harmless to the body. So for example, chromium-6, it turns into chromium-3, which is one of the only bioavailable forms of chromium to the human body. I mean, you can take a toxic carcinogen and turn it into chromium-3. How cool is that? That's what these minerals are able to do. It seems like they just touch everything that's not supposed to be in water and neutralize it and allow the water to heal itself. They've been tested and proven to take out heavy metals like lead, mercury, and arsenic from water. They've been tested and proven to completely remove fluoride,
proven and tested to remove chromium 6, turns into chromium 3, like I just said. It's been tested and proven to remove over 80 different types of volatile organic compounds, E. coli, coliform bacteria, chlorine, chloramine, and chemical contaminants, the least of it. It helps your body detoxify and remove heavy metals from your body, like I said earlier. And how it does that is, like I said, these minerals are in a magnetic sulfate forms. These minerals are bioavailable to the body. They bind with these heavy metals, for example, and other toxins, and turn them inert. They turn them into a sulfate form. So, for example, if you have aluminum in water, which is toxic to the body, very toxic, it turns it into aluminum sulfate, which the body can deal with. Actually, aluminum sulfate, aluminum in its bioavailable form, rather, is one of the most prevalent elements in nature and in food today. And the body can deal with it. Aluminum itself, it cannot. So these sulfates are able to bind with the toxic stuff and turn them in there through this magnetic process. You can detoxify your body and remove accumulated heavy metals and other toxins. So I'm going to read for you a few testimonials and success stories we've received over the years of people drinking water treated with these minerals right now, because it's just really exciting. And just a little disclaimer before I read this, I want to make it absolutely clear that the client letters we have received are based on the unique experiences and circumstances of a few people only. Results are atypical. We cannot promise that you will experience similar benefits by using this product. Okay, got that out of the way. Okay, so here's a letter from Greg. Just so you know, I have had lower back pain for over a decade. I have been to chiropractors, had scans done, taken MSM, nothing had worked. Just 3 or 4 days of drinking water, and my back pain is gone. Wow, changed my life. Thank you so much for you guys for introducing me to such an amazing product. Peace, Greg. Here's a letter from Marla. I just wanted to share my experience with black mica. I am a 40-year-old female, and ever since going off birth control pills 6 years ago, I had not had a menstrual cycle. My diet has been pretty much the same for the last 8 months. No real changes, except 4 weeks ago, I started drinking this water. Thanksgiving morning, I was surprised to find that I started my period for the first time in 6 years. I also have the no tartar on my lower anterior teeth, which is totally out of the norm for me. Just that I'd share with you. Take care, and thank you for all you do. Here's a pretty wild story of this woman's experience with these minerals. In 1998, I had an auto accident which really crushed my right heel and had to have a plate and several screws to put the heel back together. I'll try to make the story short. It got infected and would not heal, so the doctor went back in and removed the plate and screws, but it still would not heal. And so they took one of my six packs from my stomach, ouch, and in a 12-hour surgery put the muscle in my ankle. I also had some problems headlong, so they started a series of oxygen treatments, and it was more successful. Then a year later, they went back and shaved off the bigger portion of that muscle so I could wear regular shoes. I had to go to oxygen therapy for that surgery to heal. So after 4 surgeries, my foot finally healed. But when walking for any distance, my foot swells at that ankle. It also would hurt to walk on it, like the bones were going to go through the meat of the heel. Ouch. Now, after drinking water with these minerals, my foot is no longer swelling. Also, I don't feel like the bones are trying to slice through the meat of my foot. I'm so happy about that part. Elena, this is a story from Natalie. About 8 months ago, I went on a high raw diet while getting off birth control. My face went from having regular minor breakouts caused by the birth control method of my choice to being constantly inflamed and itchy. The itch was an ever-present reminder that my face looked like an orange peel in most places. I tried everything, facial care, lots of green juice, cut down on fruit, although couldn't do it without it completely. Some changes yield minor results, but breakouts still kept on reoccurring all the time. I got a 3-pack of black mica, and with a week of drinking the water, my face cleared up, not a single breakout. To my amazement, my skin felt smooth again. 8 months of trial and error, and then it took a week for my problem to disappear just like that. Thank you, thank you, thank you. My very best, Natalie. Another letter here from, I think this is the last one, yes, from Joy. Hello, Casper. I've listened to your show. I've been drinking the water for about a month now. I can't tell you the difference in my energy levels, sleeping, and urinary health. My husband is also taking it faithfully. I'm a senior who has raised 5 sons. I've been taking
I've been into alternative medicine all their lives. I must say I was a bit skeptical at first, but after researching, I decided to give it a try. I have had an acid reflux bout for a few years. I stay gluten-free 98% of the time, still had bouts until I drank the water. I have been telling friends and family about it. My husband with high blood pressure and sleeping problems has now, they have seized as well. Oh, it's a typo. He hasn't seized, but thank you, Joy. Okay, and here's a little this is from Scott Pegerson, someone who submitted blood tests for us showing arsenic and blood, arsenic at 8 levels, UG per liter, mercury in the blood at 2.4, aluminum at 9 UG per liter. After I think about, I don't remember the dates of this study he did, of these tests, April, the dates are not here. Oh no, this is just, yeah, they're here, they're 10, 13, 12. This is just a month of drinking this water. His heavy metals in his blood went down significantly. Arsenic went down by 2 points. Mercury went down from 2.4 to 1.8, and aluminum went from 9 to 5. That's a significant reduction in just 30 days of drinking the water. So besides being able to remove all the stuff from your water and remove the crap, the accumulated stuff in your body, this is not just taking all the bad stuff out. This is what I love about this. You are able to put a lot of good things in, which are necessary, essential minerals, and get that into your water. You can flood your body with bioavailable organic minerals. Most of the time, we drink water that is totally depleted of minerals. Now, water filters are great. Like I said before, it's not exactly the complete answer because you take everything out, but you take everything out, so you're not putting the good stuff back in. You cannot survive, or you can survive, but you cannot thrive on just H2O alone. Your body needs minerals. And a simple fact is most of our food is depleted because our soils are depleted of these essential minerals from toxic farming, toxic agriculture. There, you have to get a source of bioavailable minerals into your body. Most of us have no clue about this, and we don't have a source of that. So many diseases have been linked to mineral deficiency. Mineral deficiency right now is an epidemic. I'm not getting into the research on that here as we're running out of time. But iron, magnesium, potassium, calcium, phosphorus, sodium, zinc, these are some of the most essential minerals that you need in your body. Magnesium deficiency is one of the most common things today. It's often misdiagnosed because it does not show up in blood tests. Only 1% of the body's magnesium is stored in the blood. And millions suffer daily from this issue without even knowing it. Dr. Norman Shealy is a neurosurgeon, a psychologist, and founding president of the American Holistic Medical Association. For over 3 decades, he has been at the forefront of alternative medicine and alternative healthcare. He is the author of several books, including Energy Medicine, Practical Applications, and Scientific Proof. And he's a known expert of magnesium deficiency and mineral deficiency. One of the things he says is every known illness is associated with a magnesium deficiency. Magnesium is the most critical mineral required for electrical stability of every cell in the body. A magnesium deficiency may be responsible for more illnesses than any other nutrients. Some symptoms of magnesium deficiency can actually be thirst. Thirst can mean not only lack of water, but it can also mean that one is not getting enough nutrients and electrolytes. Magnesium, potassium, bicarbonate, chloride, and sodium are some principal examples, and that is one of the reasons magnesium chloride is so useful. One of the things I love about drinking water with these minerals is over time you find you don't get as thirsty because this is able to hydrate your body so much more effectively for reasons I'm about to show you than just drinking plain water that's filtered, that your body is not in this constant thirst. And also because you're finally actually drinking water with minerals, not just dead empty water, you're getting the things your body wants. The reason why we're thirsty all the time is because your body's saying, you know, I want nutrients, and give me the nutrients, where are they? And you're getting that response from the brain. When you get the minerals in your body, it's a different story. But the symptoms of magnesium deficiency, the beginning symptoms could be leg cramps, foot pain or muscle twitches, loss of appetite, nausea, vomiting, fatigue and weakness, numbness, tingling seizures, personality changes, abnormal heart rhythms, and coronary spasms can also occur. Continuing with the symptoms of magnesium deficiency, the central nervous system is markedly affected. It can include insomnia, anxiety, hyperactivity, restlessness with constant movement, panic attacks, agoraphobia, and premenstrual irritability. So magnesium, extremely important. Like I said before, not all minerals are equal. If I were to just feed you a magnet, you wouldn't suddenly have a great abundance of magnesium in your body, because you have to have magnesium in a bioavailable form for your body, and that's exactly what these minerals let you get. Aluminum, like I said before, it's harmful to the body, but aluminum sulfate, silicate sulfates, are bioavailable. So not all minerals are equal. To get these minerals into your body, you need a source of bioavailable minerals. I've already said that. Black mica extract, Add Your Clarity black mica extract, has iron, magnesium, potassium, manganese, sodium, zinc, and there is just a ton of other trace minerals here, which I haven't put in the slide because it's a long list, including aluminum, chromium, cobalt, copper, germanium, ruthenium, lithium, molybdenum, nickel, just a ton of stuff that you're normally supposed to get from nature and that we don't get today. Okay, that's what I just said, up to over 100 trace minerals of aluminum, chromium. Yeah, that's what I just said on the bottle. I made these slides like 3 days ago. I forgot what I wrote in here. Okay, this is here to remind me to play this video for you. The Hippocrates Health Institute recently tested these minerals for almost a year, I believe. And they found an increased amounts of beneficial minerals in people, and a decrease of the harmful stuff, and a whole host of other benefits. And Dr. Brian Clement actually agreed to do an interview with us and talk about his findings. So I'm going to play a few clips of what he has to say about these. You may be familiar with Hippocrates or not, but here's what Dr. Brian Clement has to say.
Well, as you know, the Hippocrates Institute is the first and foremost and oldest natural health center on the planet. This is our sixth decade. And two types of people come here. Very, very ill people and very seriously healthy, smart people come here. And what we do is we bring them back to themselves. We give them the tools to utilize in their life to make themselves well psychologically, physically, and spiritually. And so I became quite interested in what Nat produced many years ago. And minerals have always been a central role in nutritional science. And when I tested these minerals, they were outstanding. There was something quite unique about them that I hadn't found in my 40 years of experience in the past.
So last year, you agreed to test Add Your Clarity here at Hippocrates, and we'd like you to explain the results on your findings.
Well, let me rephrase it. I didn't agree to. I discovered this product, and of course, I scrutinize anything that Hippocrates gets involved with, and there was some political debate that surrounded this product. And before I went forward, I wanted to either dismiss that debate and scientifically validate that that was wrong, or not. And so we not only utilized our willing and ready guests who come here, but many members of our medical team, including Dr. Anna Marie, my wife, and myself. We did very serious and in-depth blood tests where we looked at minerals in our bodies and things that ought not to be there, heavy metals, etc., and did it before we started the product, took the product for several months and did this with a number of people, and at the end repeated that sophisticated test and found out that things that ought not to be there were lessened, things that should be there were increased. The importance of these minerals that we just discussed is the fact that they're ionic, they're electrically charged, which makes it quite unique to a rock mineral. That comes in plant minerals, but not in rock minerals that I know of. And let's explain water to you. You know, everyone immediately, when we speak about nutrition, go to food. Food is not the most important nutrient. The number one is oxygen. Without it, in 7 minutes, we're not here. Water, approximately 4 days, and we're not here. So with that said, over the last decade and a half to 2 decades, there's been an emerging science that has been even frightening to me, that shows that every drop of water that we consume as humans on this earth, the more than 7 billion of us on this earth, are contaminated now with pharmaceutical drugs, with plastics. They went to the outreaches of the North Pole and South Pole and found out that the fish in the most pristine waters, little lakes and ponds, nobody lives thousands of miles from there, no human, are contaminated with plastics. and that the little male fish, that 80% of all the male fish in the 250 cleanest bodies of water on the planet Earth, generally thousands of miles from humans, have now become females. They become transsexual because of the plastics. So how important is it to purify water? I cannot think of anything more important in front of us in nutritional science today. Water is 70% of your body, 70% of the Earth, reflecting what I said a few minutes ago. Everything is really the same on the planet. When you look at the transport of nutrients into the human cell, it's water that does that. And what makes this quite unique, more unique than anything else I've ever seen, is without manipulation, without magnetic and electrical manipulation, that this symbiotically, through biology, nature's evolutionary biology, created a way to create the fourth phase of water. Now, let's talk about the first three phases. We all learned about this as young boys and girls in school. The first is fluid or liquid. We all know that. That's what you put a spigot on, or in a swimming pool, what we fill it with. Number two is solid. That's ice. And number three is vapor. Now, the fourth phase of water that this contains is pulls things in and pushes things out. So it's sort of like a transfer, and it's a receptor site. So it makes things happen, but it converts and transmutes what's actually happening and transforms it into something else. So this is how the purification occurs. And there's really solid science on this today. And as a matter of fact, it's an emerging science and has opened up an entire new world of biology. Because when we talk about a fourth phase of something as important as water that makes up most of your body and most of the earth, we're talking about the profound foundational truth that prevails when it comes to biology and the way it works in the body. But to make this user-friendly for the listener, when you take nutrients, be it the organic plant-based food that we consume here at Hippocrates and help heal people with, or be it a whole food nutritional supplement, it is going to allow that to actually be absorbed into the human cell at a much higher level. The utilization of nutrients are always going to be much better when you do it along with this water. Why we want this and why it's part of the Hippocrates Life Give line is quite simple. Because every time we take it, it's going to enhance the biofrequency, the electrical charge of every cell, 100 trillion cells in your body. But it's going to also allow more nutritional absorption from the food you eat, the juices you drink, and the whole food supplements you consume.
Are there any other products on the market that are like these ionic sulfate minerals?
There is absolutely no other product on the market. That this gentleman pioneered something very important along with his mentor from Japan. And I think that this is the beginning of something very powerful. The usage of this product or these minerals is going to be endless. That we now talk about the human impact and the health impact of that. I think we can talk about the water purification of all of those pharmaceutical drugs that we speak about that's in every drop of water that people are now consuming everywhere in the world. Mm-hmm. I don't care if you're in the furthest outreaches, you are drinking pharmaceutical drugs. And so this is a encyclopedia of potential. And it's really a powerfully interesting thing to watch. And I'm happy that I'm here to help start to push this into the biological sciences. Mm-hmm. It's always an honor for me to be at the cutting edge of anything. Mm-hmm. I've aspired to do that since I was a young man. And I continue to do that with what I'm doing now. And I'm sure that with your help and what's going to happen with this product, we're going to change humanity.
Yeah, I believe that.
Yes.
That's why I'm sitting here.
<Good for you.
laughs> So thank you very much.
Thank you
very much for your work and your time. God bless you both.
So, you know, one of the things he was talking about is how important minerals are for the body and hydrating the body and getting nutrients into your body. If you think of water as the highway for nutrients to enter your system, wouldn't it make sense if you have the highest quality water on the earth that you would have an increased uptake of beneficial minerals and vitamins into your body? For me, that's common sense. And we were talking about earlier about mineral deficiency, and this is where I want to wrap this up, because the question is, where do these minerals come from? You know, most people say minerals come from rocks. Then are we in a shortage of rocks right now? Why are our soils and our water sources so depleted of minerals that are essential to life? And like I said earlier, these minerals are usually found near slow-moving volcanic eruptions. They come from deep within the earth. This is why you normally only find them in the water that comes from natural hot springs and mineral springs, which are found in volcanoes. Healing hot springs and mineral springs have been known to extract toxins out of the body. They've been used for thousands of years to reverse disease in ways modern medicine and science is just beginning to understand. This is the key to healing water and restoring its healing properties. This water is in its primordial state when you do this, and is loaded with life-giving minerals. However, Shimonishi was also tapping into something else. Structured phase 4 water. And I don't have a lot of time to get into this, but I really want to squeeze this in here before we end the webinar. Water can turn into ice, liquid, and gas, but it can also turn into something else. It can turn into structured water, or what scientists are calling now these days fourth phase water. This is the same type of water that is found in mineral springs and hot springs, like I've been mentioning over and over again, all around the world, which has been known to have effects on people, positive effects on people. Structured water molecules look like these six-sided snowflake-like configurations, almost like a honeycomb structure. And these six-sided honeycomb-like formations look and behave like living cells. It appears like a living being, which makes a lot of sense. These cells actually vibrate at a frequency 40,000 times faster than normal water. They resonate at a frequency, get this wavelength, very close to the range which your cells thrive at, which is 3 to 9 microns. And this type of water can store light and even store and transmit energetic information. One of the guys who's at the forefront of this research, or actually the guy, is Dr. Gerald Pollack of the University of Washington. And he's been one of the leading researchers in this field. His work is absolutely groundbreaking because his main focus is understanding how the structured water interacts with our cells, the mitochondria and the surface of the cell. He's published numerous papers, even a book on the topic. And he says that if one doesn't understand how water interacts with the cell, then you have no clue how the cell actually functions. I mean, these guys are making an absolute breakthrough in biology. He says that the water in your cells and around your cells are absolutely vital to your health because it makes a big difference in how your cells interact with proteins, which are the building blocks of life. It's possible that this type of water, drinking this type of water, is the key to healing and longevity because there's great evidence that suggests this type of water increases cellular healing. Very interesting when you look at the stories and everything we've read so far. When the muscles in your body are aching, we tend to think that it's the muscle that is in trouble. Well, Dr. Pollack is saying that it's actually the water and the protein around the muscle cells that's not functioning. Cultures that drink this type of structured water from mineral springs have been historically known to live longer. So if you structure your water, this can have a profound positive effect on your health. And that's a repeat bullet point, which we had from the other slide. Recent testing of Adiclarity Black Mica has shown high rates of UV absorption, which is a clear sign that it actually structures the water. So again, this changes how your cells absorb nutrients and how they behave. This is very, very big. So to truly get the best water on Earth, you've got to do these three things. You've got to remove the chemicals, the toxins, and neutralize the harmful organic matter, the bad minerals and heavy metals inside your water. We can do that. You have to structure the water, take it to phase 4, we can do that. And you have to fill the water with life-giving minerals. And we can do that with this. This is why I say Dr. Shimonishi cracked the code, because his black mica extract does all of these things at the same time. This is something to me that is absolutely priceless in my life. And if you think of in terms of emergency preparedness, it's extremely valuable. If you think back to what happened in Hurricane Katrina and some of the most recent natural disasters on the East Coast, many people, hundreds of thousands, were left without water and forced to try to get water from FEMA, which also didn't have water. They had to buy the water, guess from who? Nestle, from local bottled water companies. It's frightening. With this, you can be prepared for no matter what happens, you know you will have clean water in your home and your family will survive. And one of the best things about this is you only need a tiny amount to purify a large amount of water. I've got a little cup of water here normally to purify this water. I mean, this is already purified. I put it through a whole system. I just take a little eyedropper and blop,
And that's it. It's 1,000 to 1. So 5 to 8 drops for an 8-ounce glass of water, or more depending if you want more. If your water is particularly dirty, we recommend 5 to 8 drops. 3 teaspoons for a 3-gallon bucket. The water stays good for up to 8 months. This is a beautiful thing. You can take water, treat it with these minerals, put it on the shelf, and it will stay good for up to 8 months. Now, I'll let you in on a little secret. Actually, the water stays good for virtually forever. We just have to say 8 months because a lot of people misunderstand this. They think, oh, it stays good for 8 months. But if you don't touch it, if you keep introducing more toxins to it, or if you swim in it, then of course it won't last that long. It will stay good for only up to 8 months. But you can actually store water with this just for storage purposes. With these minerals, the water will stay good virtually forever. I mean, just because the oxygen in the water and how these minerals work, I don't want to get into chemistry, but that's what it does. It keeps the water activated. The cleansing properties of the water, they're active. You can use it to clean food. You could fill that 3-gallon bucket, for example, and use these minerals to clean food, and they work amazingly well to get toxins out of greens, vegetables, things that are normally exposed to a lot of agricultural contaminants. Another great thing you can do with these minerals, and what people have found, is use it in baths. These minerals have been found to be very beneficial for the skin. You can use about 5 tablespoons to purify an entire bathtub of water. I do that once in a while. It's amazing what happens. It seems to just take all the accumulated crap in your skin and just take it out. Your skin feels so smooth and soft after. Okay, so we've just scratched the surface here in this webinar, and there's so much more I would love to share with you about these minerals and this amazing technology. But we have to wrap things up. So before I go, I want to show you how you can get some of these right now and get in on a very special deal that is just for you guys here on this webinar. Okay. Normally, a 32-ounce bottle of these minerals, which is about a 6-month supply. I've been using this for months, and it's barely gone down, barely used half of it. It lasts a long time. Normally, it costs about $150 to $200. It's not a cheap product, but it lasts a very long time, and you can purify a heck of a lot of water with it. And like you've seen so far, it's pretty much worth it. And the eyedropper bottles cost about $25 each. These are great for traveling or sharing with people, going out to restaurants, putting the water wherever you go, treating your water. However, on this one-time webinar special, I'm going to throw in one of the 32-ounce bottles, and you can get 2 of the eyedroppers for free, which would normally be a value of about $200. For you right now, it's $149.50. But I'm not done yet. If you're really serious about this and you want to prepare your family and get in on a very good deal, for the next 15 minutes only at this webinar, I'm going to do something very special for you. I'm going to sound like a used car salesman. you can get 3 bottles. Instead of paying $150 each, you can pay $125. And you can get 6 of these eyedropper bottles, which would normally be a value of $150. You can get it for free. So we'll throw 6 of these for you for free. So this comes up to a value of over $600. You get it for just $374.95. Okay, and I'm not finished yet. The ultimate family preparation package, 6 bottles. Instead of paying $150, you pay only $100. Total cost of these bottles will be $900. You're going to get them for just $600. And 12 of these eyedropper bottles, which is a heck of a lot of these. Normal cost of these would be $300. You get them for free. Okay, so that totally comes up. The total comes up to $1,200. You pay just $599.95. And of course, this comes with a lifetime 100% money back guarantee. If you're unhappy with your purchase for any reason at any time, simply let us know and we'll happily return the investment, even if you don't return the bottles or use all of the product. We don't care because we stand firmly behind this product.
Okay, but only if you're on part 2 or part 3, because if you're on part 1, ha, we're still talking. We just trolled you. Okay. Now, they've got a bunch of different products here. The one I bought is a 2-ounce. Obviously, it's a bit pricey for the moment. Like, look at how expensive the filter is and everything. But this stuff is pretty kick-ass, which is why we're suggesting, you know, obviously watching the video. And obviously, before I go into, you know, the instruction manual on this, me and Rich are going to talk about what we saw when we watched this first video and why it's so freaking kick-ass as far as we could tell. And first, I'm going to let Rich explain his thoughts on it, get his perspective.
Well, my first reaction initially to this product was one of mixed feelings because, you know, I've seen many other, you know, miracle products, you know, that they claim can do everything and, you know, claim can cure this and alleviate that. And, you know, it's like it kind of started out with that traditional, like, okay, yeah, uh-huh, yeah, cut to the chase. But then they start rolling the footage of, you know, I mean, I wanted to believe it was true, you know, at first. And, you know, he was talking about all the benefits and all this stuff that it can do, or he claims that it can do. And then they start rolling the footage of the Japanese scientists pouring this stuff en masse into public water sources, and all the green gunk and all the garbage that's in the water literally after, like, you know, 2 hours clumps up and turns into nothing more than inert.
Well, it wasn't. I don't think it was 2 hours. I mean, the guy put
well, I'm just saying whatever the time was. It was probably more like 8 hours, I bet. But whatever the time frame, it was, you know, it cleaned out all the water, and they literally put, you know, a glass mug with a handle down there. They scooped the water up. One of the scientists literally drank some of it. It was so freaking clean. So I mean, you know, when I saw that, I'm like, oh, wow, I see there's some science behind this. It's not just airy-fairy, you know, like we've all heard in those health commercials bullshit that isn't backed by any form of reality. It's just a bunch of quote-unquote figures. Yeah. They're not just fooling you with a placebo. It's literal, actual, you know.
Cool thing is they didn't claim... They didn't claim that it will or won't cure anything. They were just reporting back the scientific data that they had, and what data they have is what data they have. No more, no less.
Well, that's when they went into the deeper details. But when I first started watching it, it just kind of sounded to me like a, you know, they were going, oh, yeah, we got this wonderful product that's really kick-ass, and it does all of this stuff, and, you know, bragging about it. And then they went into the details behind it, obviously, as you just stated. And,
The thing that impressed me the most is they kind of started out with the bad news first, if you know what I mean. They were explaining the science behind exactly why our water is toxic and how, and going into the science of how things got screwed up in the first place and why. So I'm like, okay, this isn't just, you know, some guy up here like, here's my magical doohickey, drink this, and woo, wonderful. No, he is just like, all right, I know we got to go into the bad, depressing stuff first in order for this to be believable. I'll get through it as fast as I can, bear with me, but, you know, here's all the nasty, depressing, toxic data, you know. So it's like that, I'm like, okay, you know, if he's willing to totally put the science first, then there might be something to this.
Mm-hmm. Exactly.
Because obviously, you know, if you're trying to sell a product, you know, and that's your only motivation, you're not going to be like, oh, look, here's like a half hour of depressing crap to totally turn you off and make you hit the stop button, you know. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. So his motivation wasn't just to, you know, to sell a product or whatever. So I'm like, yeah, all right. This is cool. He's doing the science, and those who can't stomach the hard truth of it, well, fuck them. They're not ready for the truth anyway. You can't handle the truth. Yeah, our water on this planet's gotten pretty fucked.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, hence the other two videos, Advanced Water Science and Hidden Toxin Cover-Up, which are the two videos that me and Rich haven't even watched yet, but, you know, we're going to. And the way this stuff purifies the water, it basically, it does it electromagnetically. because everything that's toxic has a version of itself that's inert. And this thing takes toxic chemicals and radioactive stuff, converts it to its inert form. I mean, and, you know, it'll even kill a lot of biological and chemical agents and so on and so forth, bringing that to its inert form. It just seems, basically, it seems to put imbalance back into balance. So I can't really say that this will or won't, quote unquote, cure anything. All I can say is, based on my observations, it takes imbalance and puts it back into balance. Now, our bodies take in all these different toxins and stuff, and our immune systems, you know, are not running nearly as efficiently as they should, so we hold on to a lot of these toxins. And every time I personally have successfully done anything to kick toxins out, you know, it feels like the Incredible Hulk is just like, you know, ass raping me or something. It's just, it's not a pleasant experience. And anytime that I'm adding nutrition in to where maybe I was at a deficit and I found a way to, you know, to correct that imbalance, and now I'm getting nutrition that I wasn't getting before, it feels good. My body's like, thank you, about fucking time. It's like giving me the finger and saying thank you at the same time. It's like, about damn time, Dave, you lazy bastard. You should have discovered this earlier, you know. So for all I know, I mean, hey, when I drink this stuff, I could be wrong. It might be a pleasant, energetic, uplifting experience. But in my experiences, when you're getting toxins kicked out of you, it's like getting gang raped by the Incredible Hulk. So if this thing works as good as it seems, I'm basically expecting to get my ass kicked for about a week. So that's why I'm kind of saying that I'm kind of volunteering to be a guinea pig here, because I don't know which way this is going to go. It looks like this stuff really is legit, and anything that's that good at removing toxins is probably going to make me feel like I'm losing the boxing match of my life. So I'm just kind of sitting here, you know, like bracing for impact. I've got three bottles that are, you know, being processed right now. Three different things because I'm curious. One is a bottle of Code Red, which is essentially, or Big Red, or whatever the fuck it is. It's cream soda, basically. The other bottle, the second bottle is just, you know, bottled water, you know, and each of these are 2-liter bottles, by the way. And the third bottle is this, you know, the citrus pop sort of stuff. And, you know, they say that, you know, and I'm going to explain the measurements and everything here shortly, but, you know, X amount of this stuff per X, you know, in each bottle, and then, you know, let it sit for at least 24 to 48 hours. I'm going for at least 48. It's been 24 already. And it says, you know, make sure, you know, it's exposed to the air so, you know, that all three caps are off so that any, during this process, anything that it's breaking up or releasing in gas form can then, you know, evaporate out of the bottle and, you know, not go back in. So the caps have to be off. And that's also why I'm going to be reading out of this instruction manual, because it explains, you know, what it is and the ratios of things. And then how I took that and, you know, came up with my measurements on it. And, you know, why I'm doing what I'm doing. This manual isn't, like, incredibly hellaciously long. half of it explains the little water purifier mechanism that they sell on here for $200. I'm going to completely skip that section because I didn't purchase that. So I'm not going to speak on something that I'm not experimenting with, but half of the manual covers this thing, the Adya Clarity water filtration system. So I'm literally going to skip reading the second half of this manual because I didn't purchase that. I'm not screwing with that. So I'm not going to speak on it. So I think that's fair. Okay. So what is it? Adya Clarity, and there's a lot of terminology here. Excuse me if I mispronounce any of it. You know, it is what it is. Okay. Adya Clarity is a blend of a purified water and ionic sulfate minerals that provide a simple yet revolutionary way to purify your water. Without the use of toxic synthetic chemicals, AduClarity converts over 250 contaminants into harmless substances and delivers a pure, refreshing taste to your water. AduClarity is extracted from black mica. That's, you know, the word black. We all know how to spell black. Mica is spelled M-I-C-A. Scientifically known as biotite, B-I-O-T-I-T-E, a powerful combination of the Earth's naturally occurring minerals, including iron, potassium, and magnesium. Through a proprietary process, U.S. patent number 4776963, black mica is extracted for water purification. In the U.S., AduClarity is registered and marketed for water purification. AduClarity uses the same ingredients as AduMinerals, which have been reviewed by Health Canada as a natural health product and approved with natural product number 800028256. AduClarity is a water purification tool. The ionic sulfate minerals in AduClarity advocate water's natural ability to filter out chemical and biological contaminants. After this purification process, water is turned back into its clean, pristine, and primordial state, hence the name of the product, Adia, which means primordial or original best state in Sanskrit, classical language of Indian. Indian meaning India. The science behind AduClarity. Water purification. AduClarity contains ionic sulfate minerals that have anemonic and catatonic, or cation, C-A-T-I-O-N-I-C, cationic, whatever, exchange properties, which is the ability to donate or receive electrons. It activates water's natural ability to cleanse itself from chemical and biological contaminants. And it shows a little diagram on here, which is irrelevant because the video does like way better than the diagram. Two, forming stable and balanced minerals. The powerful ionic sulfate minerals break up the weak bonds of harmful minerals. Because a balance of minerals is present in AduClarity, ions are rearranged to form strong and stable mineral bonds. For example, when AduClarity is added to water, sodium fluoride, a toxic mineral salt, which has a relatively weak bond, is converted into calcium fluoride, a harmless mineral salt that appears naturally in underground water sources and in seawater. In other words, fluoridated water, bam, clean, fuck you globalists. Three, keeping your water fresh and clean. AduClarity activates oxygen that can break down waste and neutralize contaminants, rendering them inert or harmless. The activated oxygen also kills disease-causing microorganisms and prevents bacteria from growing. So the harmful contaminants that make your water rot could no longer grow in the water. Because, yeah, obviously, you know, everything's interconnected, so it's like, just as the positive biological life needs certain things to thrive, the nasty little viruses and bacteria and things have their own stuff that they need to thrive that is kind of like kryptonite for us, so to speak, if you know what I mean. So, you know, you remove the stuff that the nasty shit needs to thrive, and the nasty shit can then at that point go fuck itself. Four, lab results. Benefits proven by science. AduClarity has been tested in and proven by the Environmental Protection Agency, or the EPA. You know, those assholes that are fucking with people for building ponds and charging $50,000 fines every day and stuff to, you know, innocent farmers and ranchers and stuff who are doing nothing other than existing because the EPA is a bunch of cocks. But anyway, it's been, you know, tested in and proven by those asshole buttfuckers in a certified laboratory to reduce and to remove contaminants. Tested and proven by two separate human clinical trials to be safe for consumption, and AdiClarity also removes heavy metals from a human body. Yes, hence the before mentioned ass kicking that I was mentioning earlier, that I'll be pleasantly surprised if it doesn't have that effect. But whenever I've had toxins removed from my body by any means, it feels like the Hulk is raping me. All results are available at www.waterliberty.com/research.php.
I just want to bring this to attention, just because I'm looking around. It is kind of interesting to note, just on the Hangout, just to bring up, I'm reading a naturalnews.com article, and it was published on April 24th of 2012, and it's titled "Consumer Alert: Black Mica Extract, AdiClarity Still Being Sold as Dietary Supplement Across the USA." And according to this guy by the name of Mike Adams, editor of naturalnews.com, apparently he is saying that it's being fraudulently marketed as a miracle health supplement and has been renamed and is currently being sold across America by over a dozen distributors. And the product consists of metals, iron, aluminum, etc., dissolved with sulfuric acid into liquid form. It has been heavily marketed as a dietary supplement for internal consumption, along with completely unsubstantiated health claims, which he obviously hasn't really done research. But he's essentially saying it's mined from rocks and metals near Fukushima, Japan, which wherever he got that evidence, I'd like to know.
Yeah, no kidding. Look at the screen if you're not already, Rich.
Yeah.
They go over this.
Who knows? He very well could just be a globalist shill trying to knock it down. He's also saying the Health Canada fraud. He's here. I'll send you the news article. We can even discuss this one. I thought it was kind of interesting. I was looking at Black Mica, and this was the first link on Google.
Yeah,
this natural health.
I mean,
what's that tell you?
Renowned for pulling that shit. Any misinformation bullshit that they want people to see first always ends up in, you know, in the top links.
As of today, Adya Inc. lists no Canadian distributors on its website, but it continues to point to Health Canada registration in order to falsely imply that some sort of product safety and approval status. You know, and he's basically calling the people who give testimonials in the video mentally insane, saying that high amounts of aluminum poisoning actually create, you know, saying that aluminum consumption is directly linked to mental insanity.
You're gonna get more freaking aluminum from the canned soda you drink than that. I mean,
yeah,
that
exactly.
The people slandering the stuff, they're the ones that sound fucking loony to me. I mean, that's just my opinion. Mm-hmm. And, you know, so, mm-hmm. you know, they formed a rebuttal and, you know, they are pointing, to all the sources and everything. And they're giving you all the scientific data. AdiClarity is not dissolved in battery acid. but it just, you know, it sounds like someone's just... You know, just talking
well,
about.
I think they're actually trying every point in skimming, and they reference this as the.
You're breaking up a little bit, Rich.
Testing 1, 2, 3.
Okay, you were just kind of you were stretching like worse than Max Headroom for a second.
saying is they reference the battery acid thing in this. I think this is the article they are referring to.
Yeah. I mean, to me, it reminds me of those people on the news that say, if you disagree with the government, you're a homegrown terrorist and you should be medicated, put in prison, or shot. And, you know, they're calling everybody else loonies who disagrees with government policies. Like, if you don't bow down and worship Obama's, you know, fucking dick, then you're mentally unstable and should be put in prison or medicated or whatever. And it's just like, oh, come on, really? So it sounds like the same sort of slander, you know?
Yeah. Well, I'm taking this with a grain of salt because it is, in fact, the very first link on Google.com.
Yeah, that is always suspect.
It's the number one link. And then the second one is AdUclarity Black Mica Extract Scam. The third one, customer reviews, Amazon.com, you know.
Exactly. You know, they totally, you know, they totally like to skew that shit. I mean, that tactic has been done again and again and again and again. Anything that is, shall we say, popular opinion with the establishment, like what the establishment wants you to know, and obviously the establishment runs Google, it's easy enough for them to put whatever links they want at the top. You know, it's they run Google, they can do that, it's their code, it's their service,
well,
you know.
That's the fucking thing. Here they are telling you this is toxic, yet meanwhile they're not going to talk to you about all the fluoride, all of the garbage that they put in your food.
Yeah.
You know.
And about fluorosis.
They're not going to talk about aspartame and Diet Cola, but they will talk about black mica and make claims that it was mined out of Fukushima, Japan. Where's the evidence there?
Yeah, no freaking kidding.
And I've seen the video of, you know, the scientists, it's not literal gobbledygook. They were literally, you know, fucking putting that shit in the water and it was clearing the water up.
Yeah.
You know?
I mean, what are they going to say, that was special effects? George Lucas is in conspiracy with these, with AdUclarity, and they hired
It's about as silly as saying that it was Stanley Kubrick, you know, who did the moon landings. I mean, it's like, yeah, okay, that's totally, yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's totally true. Yes. Where did you get your tinfoil hat? But yeah, I mean, it's amazing.
And if fluoride was so good for you, why is there a condition called fluorosis? Which, if you look that up, it states that fluorosis is created by long-term exposure to fluoride. Here's an interesting one. Response to the Fukushima nuclear power facility incident, FDA.gov, Japan Ministry of Health, U.S. Customs Border Protection, Senate. They list all these different links for, you know, for extended research into it. We're not going to get into all that now, but I mean, you know, if you want to do the research, anybody.
And I will say to anybody who is skeptical, that's why I did the search right now, because I figured, okay, people are probably going to type in black mica. They're going to see that. So I figure I'm going to bring it up right now, so that way it's mentioned. Yeah. That article right there, I mean, that article has all the links. That other article, it's just got a bunch of embedded links that go to other, you know, opinionated websites made by other people, you know.
This link saw the different tests and regulations and this and that and just everything that's been done and all the scientific data, Water Liberty literally is citing its sources, whereas these slander sites are not citing sources, they're just citing other slander sites.
Mm-hmm. It's a pretty typical tactic.
One of my favorites is when you try to go to some of these sites like, you know, Make Your Own Solar or, you know, any number of do-it-yourself energy sites, You know, the browser gives warning, this site might contain dangerous viruses, and are you sure you wish to proceed? And, like, you know, scaring people away from, you know, building their own home energy sources. I find that to be hilarious when I see it. I'm like, oh, geez. Because I've come across,
yeah, no kidding.
Or I'm like, wow, really?
Yeah, exactly. No, it's so stupid. It's not even funny. You know, it's just it, to me, it's kind of like it just goes to show how when anything like this does pop up, the establishment works like quickly as possible to slander. And I mean, that article's been up there for 2 years, and it's been probably on the top page of Google's list for 2 years. You know, Black Mica.
Yeah.
Or no, not even 2 years, like 3 or 4 years now. But still, I mean, it's amazing to me, you know. So no, folks, Google isn't always your friend, and no, Google isn't always going to reference you to the proper sources. That takes discernment, and that takes deep digging.
Yeah, I love people who search Google for 5 seconds, and they call that research.
That's not research.
I research all the time. I put in words into Google, and the first results I see, those are true. It's like, what? Really? That's research? I thought research was going through every link on the first 10 or 20 pages and cross-referencing the data and see what pans out to what. I thought that's what research is. Gee, that's what I do. But no, I'm just a nut. You know, I don't do real research because I'm not like the cool kids who spend 5 seconds on Google and then call it research. I love that shit. It's funny. Should I continue reading from the book?
Yeah, go ahead.
Okay. Ingredients in a bottle of Adaclarity. Iron, 1,334.0 ppm. I think that's parts per milliliter. Or no, parts per million, I'm sorry. Which is milligrams per liter. Units used to measure mineral concentration, ppm, parts per million equals milligrams per liter. Okay. Magnesium, 451.0 parts per million. Potassium, 271.0 parts per million. Calcium, 26.3 parts per million. Phosphorus, 30.5 parts per million. Manganese, I think it's how you say that, M-A-N-G-A-N-E-S-E, 21.6 parts per million. Zinc, 2.1 parts per million. Gee, I'm not seeing radioactive gobbledygook and barium and aluminum and whatever the fuck else these idiots say.
Yeah, no kidding.
Oh, no, wait. It's just their Adaclarity contains over 100 trace minerals, including, and okay, it says aluminum, barium, cadmium, cobalt, copper, germanium, lithium, molybdenum, I can't pronounce that, nickel, rubidium, selenium, silicon, silver, titanium, tungsten, and vanadium. Since Adaclarity is delivered from a natural, or derived from a natural substance, the mineral concentrations may vary. So you've got these tiny, tiny little trace elements of things, like, you know, most people don't, you know, don't realize that, like, you know, for example, there are trace elements of aluminum in everything. And there's, like, you know, there's safety limits, obviously. Like, when you look at anything on the EPA's website, they are required to take action after, you know, amounts of this, that, and the other exceed, et cetera, parts per million, that sort of thing. So, you know, even in a natural, untampered state, you know, even back, say, in the Middle Ages, before we had all the Industrial Revolution and everything, you still had very tiny trace elements of these things in everything, in spring water, so on and so forth. It wasn't the dangerous levels. And please do note that mercury is not on the list. unlike the vaccines, but that's another story.
Yeah, we're not going to mention that.
Yeah. It's on the CDC's website, though. So anybody wanting to cry conspiracy theorist on that need only go to the CDC's website and look at their own admissions. But anyway, the scientifically proven benefits of adiaclarity. Reduces 159 harmful industrial chemicals, including 80 volatile organic compounds. Removes 100% of chlorine and reduces chloramates and trihomethaninates to undetectable limits. Reduces 99.95 of tested pharmaceuticals and basic drugs. No wonder they're slandering this. Reduces 79 different agricultural substances. Oh, gotta have our nummy nummy pesticides. Can't get rid of those. That's bad.
Mm-hmm.
Reduces heavy metals in water, including lead, arsenic, and mercury, to undetectable limits. Oh, can't have that. We need our lead, arsenic, and mercury to enhance the flavoring of the fluoride. Converts toxic chromium-6 in water to beneficial chromium-3, an essential dietary element. Nope, can't have that. Converts toxic sodium fluoride in water to harmless calcium fluoride, which naturally occurs in various water sources. Kills 4 types of disease-causing microorganisms and prevents their growth. Reduces up to 99.85 of tested bacteria, viruses, and parasites. Provides up to 100 trace minerals that are easily absorbed by the body. Now, I will note that so far, I'm not seeing any claims of any magical fucking cures. All I'm seeing is science, and it's saying it does specifically this and this way with these, you know, elements, minerals, etc. I'm not seeing anything in here that says, oh my God, it's the cure for cancer. It's the Holy Grail. One drop of this and you will ascend and meet Jesus. No, I'm not seeing anything fucking crazy in here.
It's not a magical ism.
Yes, I'm not seeing anything totally nuts and over the top here. I'm just seeing, you know, a report back from scientific testing. That's all I'm fucking seeing here. Adiaclarity as a natural health product. Okay. Let's get one thing straight. Purifying your water as best you can, that's freaking healthy. Like, that's like, that should be so common sense, it shouldn't even need to be said. Adiaclarity is a natural health product. Like, that shouldn't even need to be stated. It should be common sense that clean water is fucking healthy. If you don't have that much common sense, you're an idiot. That's just, I mean, I think this section is just for the moron.
Hold that thought. I'm going to go use the bathroom.
Okay. So I guess I will hold while he's briefly using the can here. I will continue forward when he returns from the bathroom. So, you know, thank you for holding, and so on and so on. Richard will be right back in just a moment here. Do-do-do-do-do. Yes, this is also why I like, you know, having Google Hangouts with a minimum of 3 people, so that even if one leaves, there's at least somebody else to, you know, fill up the time while the other person's gone, so that one person doesn't have to sit there ranting like a blithering insane person and going, ooh, I'm waiting for people to come back from the freaking bathroom. Ah! Insert Jeopardy theme song here. Do 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 do. Please hold. The next available Richard Hamilton will be with you momentarily. Your Google Hangout is important to us. Please hold the line, and the next available Richard Hamilton will be with you shortly. Mr. Richard, should we call you the Big Dick? Ha ha. Dick is a killer. And while you are waiting, you get to see the nice little revolving informational thingy on the screen there. But, yes, I did give these guys a call at their 1-800 number and asked some questions about it. And the lady I talked to was fairly informative, I guess. But one thing that was discussed was that part of the reason why this stuff is a bit on the pricey side right now, it's kind of a supply and demand thing. So that's kind of common sense. It's not like, you know, this is as common of a thing as, say, aspirin. So, you know, obviously, the more demand you have and the more supply you need to put out, then the more, you know, you process at once, it ends up cheaper per unit and, you know, so on and so forth. And that's just kind of a standard understandable rule, you know, when it comes to producing anything. Like, you know, when CD burner drives first came out, they were like $1,000, something outrageous like that. And like, you know, now it's like you could pick up a freaking, you know, DVD burner drive for like a cheap one for like $25. And so, you know, it's the same idea. It's a supply and demand thing. Rich, are you back yet? No, apparently not yet. Maybe he's taking a big healthy paradigm shit. I don't know. Yeah, well, while we're waiting, we may as well kind of look ahead and get an idea of how many pages we have left to read. And by the way, this is a fairly, you know, physically small size book, and the text in it is pretty large. So, you know, obviously, however many pages are left here, it's not like tiny micro pages that are going to take forever to read. Okay. It looks like the end of our reading is going to be on page 16, because then beyond that it gets into the, you know, the $200 water filter thing. And we are currently on page 6. We're beginning page 6. So it's really, you know, not that much that we have to read. I mean, small book, big fonts, we're already on page 6, stop at 16. And, you know, you've even got little picture illustrations and stuff in here. So, yeah, so we don't really have long, you know, much long to go on reading this. It's just right now I'm just waiting for Rich to get back from the freaking bathroom. Man, he's just really taking a serious paradigm shit here. I'm halfway tempted to just continue, like, reading forward anyway. Okay, fuck it. I'm tired of trying to think of the aimless things to rant about while I'm waiting. Adia Clarity is a natural health product. 1, effective in prevention and opportunity to heal. Adia Clarity is filled with ionic sulfate minerals that protect you from the harmful contaminants in your water. Adia Clarity makes these contaminants inert. So, okay, that's really nothing more than, you know, what's already been said anyway. Remove toxins build up from your body. Adia Clarity has been clinically proven to be safe for human consumption and has been found to be effective in heavy metal removal from the body by an average of 82% in 90 days. These toxic metals include aluminum, mercury, lead, and arsenic. Additionally, hydration of the cells was improved by 32%. And the results for the human clinical trial are available at waterliberty.com/PDFS/heavy-metal-90-day-final-21.pdf. Applications. Use Adia Clarity to purify water for all of your needs, drinking for your family and pets. Bathing purifies and mineralizes your bath water, making beverages, ice, coffee, tea, juice, etc. Washing produce, fruits, vegetables, etc. Obviously, you know, these are applications that it can be used for. It's obviously a bit pricey to be using for all of this stuff. So until the price comes down, obviously most of us aren't going to be using this wide scale. Cooking, pasta, soup, etc. Watering plants indoor and outdoor. A little disclaimer, flavor may slightly be altered after the addition of added clarity. Heat does not affect added clarity. In cooking, added clarity provides you with a purified water to cook your meals. Did you know boiling your water does more harm than good? Every time you cook or make a soup, you boil your water. While the water is being boiled, it evaporates and leaves a lesser amount of water in the pot. With a lesser amount of water, you will have an increased concentration of nitrates and heavy metals. Also, hot water dissolves contaminants more quickly than cold water. So always use cold tap water. Never use hot water to speed up cooking. The problem is that water is in everyone's home. Even if people don't drink tap water, they cook with it. Lead slams straight into pasta. Boil up peas in contaminated water, and the lead is in the peas. And that particular part is a quote from Michael Moore, University of Queensland, Renner, 2010. In bathing, AdduClarity purifies and mineralizes your bathing water. As a high-quality product concentrated with minerals, all you need is 3 tablespoons to add to an average bathtub, which, again, at $25 for 2 ounces can get more than just a little pricey. But, you know, it'll be really cool when the price does come down as more people start using this and the supply and demand ratio changes. Helps prevent absorption of contaminants directly through your skin. Helps avoid skin irritation caused by chemicals such as chlorine. Volatile organic chemicals escape from contaminated water, and somebody made a typo there, into the air and are inhaled during baths and showers. AdduClarity is a cost and time-saving water purifier that can minimize your exposure to toxins. And see, we're already on page 8 going into page 9. So moving through pretty quickly. Come on, pages, stop sticking together. Thank you. Instructions, conversions. How much AdduClarity should I add? The amount depends on the quality and type of water. Generally, the more contaminants are in the water, the more AdduClarity is needed to purify your water. Richard, are you back yet? I'll take that as a no. For most water, we are recommending starting with a dilution ratio of 1 to 1,000. To calculate the amount of AdduClarity you need, divide the volume of water by 1,000. Example, 1 liter of water is 1,000 equals 1 milliliter of AdduClarity. 1/5 of a teaspoon equals 20 drops. 1 teaspoon is 100 drops. To purify a large amount of drinking water, recommended dosage per 1.3 gallon or 5 liters of water. And the graph goes like this. When it comes to tap water or well water, every 5 liters is going to be between 1 and 2 teaspoons. For filtered water or spring water, 1 teaspoon. For distilled water or reverse osmosis water, 1/2 teaspoon. Here's what I basically broke this down to. In my little bottle, it's got, you know, when you unscrew the top, it's got an eyedropper built into it. And when I, you know, stick it in and, you know, suck some of the stuff into the eyedropper, it fills the eyedropper halfway. So now for things like pop, tap water, things like that, what I've figured out, you know, making it as far as, you know, the little eyedropper thing, is when I fill the eyedropper up halfway, if you got something, you know, that's going to be super polluted, like tap water or pop or things like that, I put in four of those. So I fill the eyedropper up halfway, add it to the 2-liter bottle, and I do that four times. Now, with the bottled water, that, you know, the purified water, you know, I did that two times. So, you know, that's what I figured out. You know, I went on, you know, on Google to do the, you know, the calculations and conversions of, you know, between liters and gallons and so on and so forth, and experimented with that. So I played around and basically, you know, got to that basic calculation there. To purify smaller amounts of drinking water, for most water, we recommend adding 5 to 8 drops for every 8 ounces of water. For distilled or reverse osmosis water, which is generally clean but is lacking in minerals, reduce the dosage by half from 5 to 8 drops to 2 to 4 drops for every 8 ounces. This enhances the water with essential minerals. So volume of tap water and the recommended dosage, you know, that's, it's got a chart here. 8 ounces, 237 milliliters, that's between 5 and 8 drops for tap water. And all this is for tap water that I'm reading, by the way. 16 ounces, 473 millimeters, or milliliters, excuse me. That's between 10 to 16 drops. And, of course, 32 ounces of tap water, which is 946 milliliters, or 1 quart, is between 20 and 32 drops. And, you know, like I said, got an eyedropper in there, so you can literally measure it by drops. Richard, are you back yet?
Yes, I am.
I've had to continue forward because you were just taking too long. I got tired of thinking of random bullshit to say, and I'm just like, fuck this.
So what did I miss? I went to the bathroom, then my mother came home, then now here I am.
Really nothing more than you and I have already discussed anyway. I mean, you know, AdduClarity is a natural health product, you know, effective in prevention, opportunity to heal, you know, remove toxins from your body, etc. You know, all the stuff that you and I have already discussed in private anyway about this. You know, so it's nothing you don't already know. I went into, you know, the different measurements and how I figured out as far as, you know, the eyedropper and what I added, you know, into mine and why I did it that way and so on and so forth. And that's kind of where you walked in.
Okay.
So nothing you don't already know.
Okay.
Treatment process. What should I do after adding AdduClarity to my drinking water? Stir to ensure contaminants are binding to the minerals in AdduClarity. Keep the lid off or cover loosely to allow gaseous contaminants such as chlorine and other chemicals, volatile byproducts, to evaporate. Oh, that reminds me. I didn't actually do any stirring when I added it in 24 hours ago, so I should probably cap those bottles back up, shake the shit out of them, and then let the carbonation calm down before reopening them. Because I got another 24 hours to go on letting this, you know, do its thing. Wait while treating water at room temperature. Do not refrigerate water during treatment because cold temperature slows down the reaction. The whatever the fuck word they use, I don't know, whatever. Like I said, some of the words are even more complicated and articulate than I'm used to saying. So it's just like, bleh. How long do I wait before drinking the water? The wait time depends on the quality of the original water. Longer wait time ensures all complex contaminants, such as microorganisms, are removed. If you are confident that the starting water is clean, i.e. distilled and reverse osmosis water, wait between 5 and 15 minutes before drinking. For polluted water, the suggested wait time is 24 to 72 hours. I'm going roughly on the 48. Time-saving tips. Treat 2 large batches of water at a time. when one batch of water is still being treated, you can drink the batch that is already purified. Two, adding Adia Clarity to warm or hot water would speed up the purification process. How can I determine the ideal treatment time? Treat 8 ounces of water with 5 to 8 drops of Adia Clarity, stir, and let it sit for 24 to 72 hours. Monitor the amount of sediments every 24 hours. When you stop seeing more sediments forming, this indicates that the contaminants are neutralized, and that would be the ideal wait time. Well, I'm not going through all those processes. I'm just rounding things out and, you know, kind of doing the middle average, so to speak, as I already explained. How long do I wait when treating water in a restaurant? The suggested wait time is between 5 and 15 minutes. Adding Adia Clarity to warm water would also speed up the purification process. What should I expect to see after waiting? The effects may vary depending on the amounts, turning the page here, and type of contaminants in the water. After seeing after adding Adia Clarity to your water, you may see, number one, no sediments. If the starting water is clean, i.e. distilled reverse osmosis, there may not be enough contaminants in the water to form, I can't say that word, it begins with a P, it just means the reaction that creates the sedimentation. Not all chemicals form sediments. For example, chlorine, volatile organic compounds, and other gaseous contaminants evaporate off the top. Complex contaminants like microorganisms may take longer to treat, and you may not observe the effect immediately. The recommended wait time is between 24 and 72 hours. Two, sediments at the bottom of the container. Generally, more polluted water may result in more sediment. Three, color change or cloudiness. These are signs that dissolved contaminants are coming out of the solution. Give it more time for contaminants to come together and form sediments. Four, pale yellow color throughout the water. Reduce the dosage if the color looks like ginger ale and the taste is very strong. This could be an indication that you may have added too much Adia Clarity minerals. Is it safe to drink the sediment? Though the sediment may be unpleasant to look at, it is completely harmless and safe to drink. How can I remove the sediment? Sediments are safe to consume. They are the neutralized contaminants and have been converted to a harmless form by Adia Clarity. Since they are unpleasant to look at and give a different taste to the water, we recommend filtering them out. You may also use the following simple home filtration alternatives: coffee filter, cheesecloth. Grab a clean container. Place coffee filter over container. Pour the treated water through the coffee filter. To avoid small sediments from passing through the filter, do not apply too much pressure when filtering with a coffee filter or cheesecloth. It is not necessary to pour out the last bit of water with sediments. It is completely normal that the disturbed sediments float to the top. Please note, some sediments, depending on the type and the amount of contaminants in the water, are so fine that they may pass through the pores of these filters. Suggestions: try using 2 to 3 coffee filters at one time. Use the Adia filtration system. Its 0.2 micron pore size ceramic filter can trap the finest sediments. The most effective method to remove the sediments is to use the Adia Clarity Gravity Filtration System. That's like the most expensive one. It's like a $400 system. It contains a ceramic filter with 0.2 micron pore size to trap even the finest sediments, a 4-layer earth filter as extra protection, and water taste enhancer. And then the last bit, page 16, storage. How should I store the treated water? Store water in another container made of either glass, stainless steel, ceramic, BPA-free plastic, and refrigeration is not necessary. And everything else in this manual, you know, is just, it's the filter. Oh, there's testimonials and stuff in here. Let's see here. Yeah, I think in the video, the one guy actually goes over some of these testimonials. Yep, yeah, these are the ones that were gone over in the video, so people are going to see these anyway, so it's all good. I don't need to go over them here. You and I have already seen them, and people who haven't watched those videos yet are going to see them, because I'm going to be starting to include those videos in part two of this. Okay, cool. That is, yeah, that's the whole freaking manual right here. So, any other thoughts that you have now that we've pretty much gone through all this, and the only thing left other than, you know, going through the rest of the videos and stuff is for Dave the guinea pig to do his thing.
Nothing really else to add. I mean, just simply, you know, it's a good product, obviously, because Google's putting fear porn at the very top of their page, and, you know.
Yeah, you know it's good when Google's doing the fear porn thing.
Yeah. Yeah, you know it's a surefire product. No, I don't really have anything else to add. I just can't wait to try it myself at some point and, you know, talk about my results with it in another hangout in the future and kind of go over the kind of collectivized results between you and me.
Yeah. Oh, wow. I'm looking at this, at one bottle right now. Cause remember how I said, I'm going to shake it up. Cause you know, I'd forgotten to do that. Mm-hmm. Well, I'm moving it around and there is a clusterfuck of sedimentation all in this bitch.
Really?
Like there, yeah, there's like heavy sedimentation, in this thing. I mean, obviously now I'm shaking it, so now it's a mix of sedimentation and bubbles because Bob is carbonated. I have to let that calm down before, you know, I can take the pop cap, you know, the cap off again because, you know, I don't want it just exploding all over the place because this is carbonated stuff that I'm dealing with. Alrighty, now here's the clear water. I'm going to slowly move that around and see if I see any sedimentation floating around in there. Tiny bit, not much. So
are you trying to show on screen share?
No, I'm not. I'm in another part of the room doing this because I don't have this positioned in a convenient place for that, and I've got to set up.
Okay. I'm just making sure because you've had it on the Water Liberty thing the whole time, and I wasn't sure.
Yeah, no screen
going
share.
Back and forth. So
I'm in another part of the room. I'm talking with a raised voice, you know, to make sure that you can hear me because I'm literally like away from the freaking computer right now.
Okay, got it.
Yeah, and the bottle of cream soda doesn't have nearly as much sedimentation as the other bottle of pop did, the more citrus stuff. It's got some, but like not nearly as heavy. Maybe there's like more fructose corn fuck over in the other one than this one or something. I really don't know. But that's definitely interesting. So
mm-hmm.
I'm shaking those up and I'm going to let them sit and, you know, and calm down before I uncap them again. But I had forgotten that the instructions said to stir it. And I'm like, oh, shit, well, I'm halfway through. You know, I got to wait another 24 hours. So at this point, it's like, okay. I mean, it's not really convenient to try to put a spoon in a 2-liter freaking bottle, but I could shake the hell out of it. Same effect.
Mm-hmm.
I'm also curious to find out how the pop tastes after this, you know? Because obviously it says that it may affect the taste slightly because of the alterations it's doing. So who knows, it might taste better. I mean, I might report back like, oh man, dude, this stuff tastes like twice as good now. Fucking A, you know, I mean, I don't know how it's going to taste. We'll find out.
Mm-hmm.
But yeah, I mean, I want to experiment with this myself because it's like, at this point, I can say, okay, I watched the videos. It's really cool how it can do environmental cleanup stuff and so on and so forth. But personal experience, I have none yet. So it's like, I'm like, all right, well, $25 for the little bottle and it seems really cool and everything. You know, what have I got to lose? I mean, you know, I'm just going to do a series of videos on this and report back my findings and stuff. And, you know, we'll see what happens. I mean, even if hypothetically, let's say this is a total sham and it didn't do anything, and I go through all this and I report back, well, nothing, this is just bullshit or whatever. Even if that were to happen, at least I've got the data out online. So, you know, I've put the data out and, you know, monetizing it, obviously, because I can monetize a Hangout because it's mine. Haha. So, yeah, I mean, so there's really no harm in everything to gain either way. You know, no matter whether this stuff ends up being really fucking awesome or, you know, whether it doesn't work at all or whatever, you know, at least I can put this information out. All of you out there can benefit from the information. You know, I'm going to monetize it. And of course, all Paradigm Shift and Educational Comedy episodes are completely free to download and re-upload. And feel free to monetize that if you want to. That's cool. I don't care. Make some money on it. It's Creative Commons Creative Commons license. So more power to you.
Mm-hmm.
So I just see no harm in any direction in testing this and seeing what happens, and I'm incredibly freaking curious.
Yeah, but definitely.
But just the way I figure it, if it works like it seems to, I just, you know, in my experiences, whenever I take anything that really works for kicking out toxins, it feels like I'm being raped by the incredible fucking Hulk. Just like, ooh. Party time and not a good party for me. Real good party for the Hulk, though, but not so much for me. So, yeah, I'm just kind of expecting to have, like, a week of fucking biological ass-whoop if this stuff is as good as it says. But then again, it may feel great. It may kick it out in such a way that it's like, wow, I'm feeling revitalized and wonderful and great. But, yeah, in all my experiences of detox, it feels like you're getting fucking plowed over and being made the universe's bitch. So.
Well, I mean, I wouldn't be surprised either way, you know, by the results. It says that it works. It shows, you know, that it works.
Yeah, that's kind of the part that I guess they, you know, they don't put in the you know, feedback testimonials. It's not like excuse me. Yeah. It's not like, wow, this stuff worked really great for me. But, you know, beforehand, it bent me over and made me its bitch and whooped my ass for like a week.
Mm-hmm.
They're obviously not going to put that in there.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, no kidding.
So, yeah, just in my experiences, any good detoxing stuff that really does genuinely work usually kicks your ass just totally. Just like, you know, it feels like you lost with the Incredible Hulk or Mike Tyson or whatever, backed over by a truck several times for good measure, you know.
Mm-hmm.
So that's just been my experiences. But, hey, I could be wrong. I mean, I'm not saying that there isn't such a thing as a detox that makes you feel wonderful while you're going through it. I'm just saying I haven't found it yet.
Well, yeah, generally when you're detoxing shit out of the body, it's like, you feel like you're gonna die.
Puking is a form of detox. How good does that fucking feel? Does it feel wonderful when you have the flu and you're puking your freaking guts out? No, it doesn't.
No, I've gotten sick to where I've literally let everything out of me. It doesn't feel good at all. You feel miserable. And it lasts for about 2 or 3 days.
Yeah.
The puking generally lasts about 2 days. That's generally how long long the puking goes for, and then the third day you're just sitting there afterwards going,
thank God it's over.
Yeah. I haven't gotten that sick in a long time, so I think I've gotten most of those toxins out of myself. Probably most toxins that would be coming out would be coming out through the convention. Well, yeah, it would definitely be conventional means anyway. Stuff would be flushing all of the heavy all the heavy crap out of your, you know, gut and stuff that your body's been having trouble getting rid of.
Yeah, I mean, whether this kicks my ass or not, I am, you know, I'm looking forward to, you know, seeing the results, and even if it does totally whip my ass, the positive results that come after the ass kicking. Because in the past, whenever I've done any sort of detoxing stuff, you know, there's always the beneficial results after the ass whipping. Otherwise, why bother doing it?
Mm-hmm.
Like when you change your diet in such a way to where you're not eating so much nasty stuff and you're eating more healthy stuff, that in and of itself is a detox. Because unfortunately, toxins create cellular addiction to those toxins. So then you go through the withdrawal symptoms. And it just feels like, you know, you're being taken for a not-so-pleasant ride. Just, ugh. But then after it's over, it's just like this relief. Like, you feel, like, way more vitalized and stuff. Like, when, like, for a while, I was, like, purely on, like, you know, Dr. Pepper and RC. And now I've decided to add a lot of non-colas into the mix. Like, you know, citrus type of pop with those sorts of juices, you know, bottled water, you know, brisk iced tea, things like that. And, you know, soon I'll be adding in, you know, the lucid dreaming tea with 100% pure kangaroo cock. But it's lucid dreaming tea. Go to luciddreamingtea.com. I'm going to be having some of that stuff. I've already taken some of it, like put it in my spice mixes that I put on my food. Most people don't know that tea leaves are also consumable, so, like, you can use them as herbs to flavor food and shit, too. It's pretty cool. But, yeah, I'm going to be having this in, you know, the liquid tea form as well. Just haven't gotten around to that yet, but I will be. I got my little baggie of tea here, so it's going to be interesting. I've been doing whatever I can to improve my health. I mean, I take 10,000 IU a day of Nutrigold vitamin D3, you know, I take dead sea salt, which, you know, it's the reverse of regular salt. Regular salt is high iodine, low magnesium. Dead sea salt is obviously low iodine, high magnesium. And that's the balance your bones need, because magnesium balances out calcium. So I do that. I mean, I take dandelion root tablets. I mean, sure. Could I, you know, take, you know, dandelion weeds from my garden and dry out the roots and grind it up and do all that myself? Yeah, but, I mean, you know, I'm a lazy bit, so I just got the tablets. Okay, I'll admit it there. All right. And I also take apple cider vinegar tablets, too, and I take colloidal gold and colloidal silver and so on. And have I seen improvements in my health from all this stuff? Oh, fuck yes. And I have my own little herbal mixture of stuff that I put together. Part of it I grow here, you know, at the house, and other parts of it, I purchase organic stuff online. But it's got a mixture of chili peppers and oregano and, you know, of course, the Dead Sea Salt in there, as well as iodine salt, too, because the Dead Sea Salt has a different taste to it than iodine salt. And obviously, it's not as good of a taste as the iodine salt. So I mix regular salt in there, too, to, you know, bring the taste back to where it should be. Cayenne pepper, spirulina. There's all this different stuff that, you know, I have in my little spice mix that I put on food and, It's really awesome, and it works for me. The flavoring I put together for myself is not everybody's cup of tea. No pun intended. So, you know, people who want to experiment with this sort of stuff have to, you know, just kind of see what works for you as far as, you know, what makes you feel good and what tastes good and so on and so forth. People who might not be able to handle spicy foods that well, you know, are probably not going to have the cayenne and the chili peppers and stuff like that, but, you know, they could have the, you know, the spirulina and the oregano and, you know, the Dead Sea salt and iodine salt in there and, you know, maybe a little bit of lucid dreaming tea mixed in there perhaps. And no, I don't get any commissions or anything for mentioning lucid dreaming tea. I'm mentioning it because I have it. And so there, yeah. So yeah, I mean, I've started altering, you know, my diet in more and more positive ways since 2012 and haven't really come down with like any major, you know, sicknesses since. I mean, I used to get my ass totally whooped at least a few times a year with like some kind of a bad cold or bronchitis or flu or some damn thing. And haven't had that shit happen since 2012. Also used to get chronic migraines like most of my freaking life. And now these days I hardly get them at all. And when I do, they're not nearly as bad as they used to be. So, yeah. And then, of course, I've lowered my stress levels as well. One key thing within the paradigm shifting I do is kind of, you know, grow a thicker skin, metaphorically speaking, and don't take shit so personally. Because when you take everything so personally, you're just, like, stressing yourself the fuck out about everything. And the damage that does to your body is in-fucking-credible. So, you know, learn some patience and chill out and relax a bit on stuff. Not simply just, you know, for philosophical reasons or ideological reasons, but, like, seriously, your body's health is going to improve big time. Because otherwise you're just sabotaging your immune system. Because you're releasing all that stress hormone, which is so corrosive, in fact, that they use it in anti-organ rejection medication. Because stress hormone shuts down your immune system. And the immune system needs to be shut down in order to give the body time to acclimate and accept the new organ. Otherwise, it'll see the new organ as like a foreign body and not accept it. And, you know, we'll just try to destroy the new organ, which, of course, isn't a real good thing if you've just had an organ transplant. You're going to kind of want the body to accept the organ, not reject it. Yeah. So because stress hormone is so freaking corrosive, it shuts down the immune system. That's why they put it in, you know, a synthetic equivalent of that in the anti-rejection medication. So, you know, you've got society and the news and everything focusing everybody on 24/7 fear and training us to be neurotic and be politically correct little butthurt bitches and take everything so personally. All that stress hormone running through you, what do you think that's doing to your immune system? Are you sick all the time? Are you wondering why? Do you stress out over fucking nothing like a little bitch? The stress hormones that you're pumping into your bloodstream might have something to do with it. Try new prescription strength. Damn it all. Just kidding on that last part. Also compared to the active ingredient in fuck it all. But seriously, folks, I think you all get my point at this point. So, Richard, are you back? I'll take that as a no. I don't know if there's anything else he wants to add. I pretty much said all I have to say about this for the moment, and I'm thinking, okay, probably might be a good time to close up the hangout, but, you know, I don't want to be a rude bitch, and, you know, then Rich comes back, and just like, hey, what the fuck, I was going to mention da-da-da-da-da, et cetera, et cetera. It's like, oh, sorry, didn't know. So, yeah, I'll try to wait up a few minutes here, but if he takes exuberantly long like last time, then fuck it, I'll risk being a rude bitch and just close up the hangout. But I will give him a chance to return, because what I am saying is I'll give Rich a chance to return to the hangout. I must give Rich a chance. Richard. Are you back yet, Mr. Richard? I hear movement. Is he alive? Richard, are you alive over there? Or did Kissinger break into your house and anally violate you and skull fuck you until death? No. He's not that, or wait, I'm hearing something again. Richard, is that you? Exodol! Mork and Mindy joke. Rich. Okay, well, I guess there is one. One last thing I could do, because I forgot if I actually had done this earlier. I want to show the bottle of Adya Clarity there. Of course, there's the eyedropper mechanism I was talking about, and when I fill it up, hopefully the screen will let you see that it comes about halfway. Yeah, so hopefully we can see that. And then I was mentioning, you know, before the font sizes and everything and illustrations and how the text wasn't all that big or anything. You know, just so you guys can kind of get the idea on that. Yeah. My nails are still a little freaking dirty. I was working in the garden earlier. I washed my hands like 5 different times and scrubbed around my nails. There's still a little bit of junk in there. Damn it. I love working in the garden though. It's awesome. I have a pond garden, everything like that. Richard, are you fucking back yet?
Boy, I suck at this.
There you are. We thought you were sucking on Kissinger's cock as he was like violating you and skull fucking you and murdering you over there. We heard movement, but we figured maybe Kissinger had you like bound and gagged or something as he was sticking his cock in your asshole. You know, weren't sure what was going on with you there, Rich.
That bad, huh?
Well, we didn't know. We heard a lot of, like, rustling and movement. We thought maybe Kissinger was doing some, like, S&M bondage thing with you over there. I mean,
your sick ass would like that, wouldn't you? If you're sitting on a good cooking show.
Dick is a killer.
No, it's like, no, the Fuhrer is putting on a cooking show.
So is there anything you want to say or go into or whatever before we close out this hangout? Because I think that we've pretty much said all we can say for now.
For now, yeah. No, I think we've kind of beaten it to death with I think we've beaten the horse to death with a stick.
Especially during the times when you take your extended leave and I'm just here like, okay, I gotta buy time. Fuck, what do I talk about? Look, a squirrel!
Yep.
Yes, this is tobacco. No, I'm not advocating nicotine. Kids, don't smoke and all that good stuff. Unless you're in Oregon or Colorado and it's weed and it's legal and you're 21 years or older, then knock yourself the fuck out. Have a beer while you're at it. But nicotine, stay away from it. Alrighty. I guess that's it for this episode. And After this, like I said, I'm going to take this one and splice it up and mix it with this other videos as before. And then after a week or so of this stuff either kicking my ass or not, then, you know, I will be reporting back again. So you guys have that to look forward to. So catch you later. Peace out.